morning to you. Yes, it is your Feel Good Breakfast Show, Espresso on S3. And we are super excited because we literally blinked and it's the weekend again. And we are going to make sure we've got the perfect guide for you for the next couple of days. Now, as we are building up to the next Rugby World Cup match, we're also going to get the perfect hosting menu ready for you. So perhaps you're planning on brying this weekend. How about trying our recipes for a change? Today, we're going to show you how to make a bride roasted broccoli salad with miso Caesar dressing. We're going to show you how to make a milk tart jaffles also on the braai, and then the boys bride made easy with Woolworths. We're going to make sure you have all of the tools and gadgets to have that perfect braai. Of course, it is Bock Friday too, so I'm hoping you are remembering to put your green and gold jacket and jersey on. And then we need some entertainment for your Friday, and entertaining us today is the dynamic duo Kusasa. They are here, they are so ready to entertain us, and we are so excited to be entertained by their music. And finally, we are also gearing up to the SAFTAs that's happening this weekend. We're going to connect with former Miss Universe Sozobini Tunzi, the co-host of the evening, and we are so excited to hear what to expect. They have been not just practicing, but getting ready, rehearsals to make sure that tomorrow's SAFTAs it's flawless. Well, that and a whole lot more is coming up between now and 9 o'clock, so stay tuned and let's say good morning to the G-Man. Morning, Graham.
Morning, my friend. I hope you had an amazing day yesterday and are ready for today. It's a massive weekend. I feel like we are so emotionally invested in the SAFTAs this weekend. Of course, Carlin Kutle going to be hosting the Craft Awards, so I'm so happy for all those people celebrating the jobs behind the scenes, that you get two of the best in the industry guiding you through that. And of course, then we're going to be connecting with Zozobini soon about what it's going to be like taking center stage. But we want to hear from you guys. Who do you think is going to walk away with a coveted golden horn this weekend? It means so much to the stars who have been nominated. We want to hear from you, the fans, that they do it for. 063-408-8863. Who's going to take one of those coveted golden horns? Let us know. We'll keep that conversation going for the next 3 hours. And yes, we'll also chat a little bit of sports ahead of a bumper weekend. But lest we forget, we've got to wrap up the week. So let's get in those major news stories, and then I'll touch on the sport before we launch the next 3 hours.
Thank you, Graham. Let's start off with national headlines. The Constitutional Court has dismissed Julius Malema and the Economic Freedom Fighters, the EFF's application for leave to appeal an interdict preventing them from initiating illegal land grabs. AfriForum acquired the said interdict in 2017, and an appeal brought by Malema and the EFF was previously dismissed by the Pretoria High Court. In the order, the Apex Court concluded that the application should be dismissed as it bears no reasonable prospects of success. The EFF has described the Constitutional Court's dismissal with costs as disappointing and ahistorical. And staying with our local news, the commissioner of the newly established Border Management Authority, known as the BMA, Dr. Mike Masiapata, has assured South Africans that the entity will get rid of corruption and ensure that the country's borders are safe. The BMA came into effect on the 1st of April this year. It's intended that the BMA will adapt and respond effectively to challenges, threats, and opportunities that exist in the border environment while safeguarding South Africa's borders and meeting the country's national, regional, and global developmental responsibilities and human rights imperatives. Now, moving to news abroad, Kenya has pledged to lead a multinational security force in Haiti in response to a plea from the Caribbean nation's prime minister to help restore order. Haiti has suffered from gang violence for decades, but the current wave of brutality escalated after the July 2021 assassination of President Jovenel Moïse. Gangs have taken control of large parts of the country, waging terror on residents and killing hundreds. The UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres has said a robust use of force is needed to disarm the gangs and restore order. Staying with news abroad, a 16-year-old boy has been arrested in connection with the felling of one of the UK's most celebrated trees. A landmark tree at one of England's oldest heritage sites, Hadrian's Wall, was presumably felled on Wednesday night. The wall was built by the Roman Emperor Hadrian in Northumberland some 1,900 years ago. The tree was an icon in this historic landscape for almost 200 years. It was also in a famous scene in the Kevin Costner film Robin Hood, Prince of Thieves, and is since known as Robin Hood's tree. And a shepherd in Thessaly, Greece, noticed his flock of sheep were acting very weird. In fact, they actually seemed extremely jolly, exhibiting really strange behavior, such as leaping around even higher than goats and bleating like mad. And then the bamboozled shepherd, known as Yannis Boronis, spotted the reason why they'd unexpectedly turned bad. They accidentally landed in a greenhouse and devoured some 270 kilograms of medicinal cannabis. However, Boronis has forgiven them as they initially had hastily sought refuge in the aftermath of Major Storm Daniel, which led to extreme flooding in Greece as well as in Libya, Turkey and Bulgaria. They naturally simply just couldn't resist the luscious green weeds which they literally stumbled upon. Well, on that note, that's where I leave your morning headlines. I'll be back at 7 o'clock.
Not bad, Zoe. Let's see if I can go one better. Let's start with cricket. And Laura Wolfart played a captain's knock and more yesterday to lead the Proteas women to a 7-wicket victory over New Zealand's ladies, a victory that secured the series 2-0 in their favour with one game remaining. So Wolfart struck 15 fours on her way to a fourth career century with an unbeaten 124 for 141 deliveries, so well measured, and also etched her name in the history books as the first South African women's player to score more than 3 ODI centuries. Well done. So South Africa chasing down that 254-run target with ease as former captain Sinead Lewis, who had 53 of 57, carved a half century, followed by Marizan Cupp's very confident unbeaten 45 to help steer them across the line. So that third and final ODI, now a dead rubber, that gets away underway at Sunday, 9:30 in the morning. Now, some bad news on the gents' side of the Proteas story. The Proteas captain, Themba Bavuma, has now travelled back to South Africa from India, citing family reasons for his departure. So, consequently, he'll be absent from the Proteas preparation matches for the Cricket World Cup, missing two warm-up matches against Afghanistan and New Zealand. In Bavuma's absence, Aidan Markram will take on the role of captain for these games. However, it is anticipated that Bavuma will rejoin the team just in time for their World Cup campaign opener up against Sri Lanka. That's on the 7th of October in Delhi. Now down to football, and in a thrilling showdown at the 2023 Varsity Football Final held at UJ Soweto Stadium, defending champions TUT secured their fourth title by triumphing over UJ in a dramatic penalty shootout. Oh, our nerves had to be tested. The match ended at one apiece after regular time, and despite the 2023 Golden Boot winner Ronald Mabaso missing a crucial penalty, surprisingly, TUT held their nerve in the ensuing penalty shootout to outscore UJ 5-4, thus securing their status as the 2023 Varsity Football Champions for now the second consecutive year. Congratulations. And then we turn to rugby now, and Japan made some significant progress towards the quarterfinals of the Rugby World Cup with a 28-22 victory over Samoa, securing England's spot as Pool D winners in so doing. So tries from Peter Lambaskakhni, Michael Leitch and Kazuki Himeno, combined with 13 points from fly half Rakia Matsuda, provided a comfortable lead in the end. Despite a late push from a 14-man Samoa, showed a lot of heart, Japan did hold on. So Japan is now second place in that pool with 9 points, setting up a crucial clash with Argentina next week. And if the Pumas win against Chile, as expected. So don't forget, you can catch all the action live on SABC2 radio stations and SABC Plus. No subscription fees applied. And Argentina will clash against Chile at 2:30 in the afternoon tomorrow. And then on Sunday, you can catch Sia and the boys take on Tonga. That's at live at 8:30 in the evening. So bumper sporting weekend on the way. We love that. Hopefully the weather is going to play its part. Let's get the latest on the weather front from Zoe.
Well, on that note, let's look at some news. The climate expert Johan Malharbe says the extreme weather patterns in KwaZulu-Natal are the result of the same low-pressure systems that caused last weekend's flooding in the Western Cape. Moharba says such strong low pressure systems can develop at any time of the year. However, he says climate change means that more moisture can be expected in the atmosphere, which makes heavy rain possible in shorter periods of time. The Weather Services has meanwhile warned that extremely high fire danger conditions are expected over the central and northeastern parts of the Northern Cape, including the west coast of Namakwa, the western part of the Northwest Province, and Mangkhwang in the Free State. Well, on that note, let's take a look at today's temperatures. Those are your temperatures for today. Let's take a look at your sunrise views. Janelle in Kwadukuza is showing off this blissful view of the sunrise. Look at that transformation. And Kevin in Port Edward is gearing up for the golden sky. Nadri in Abu Dhabi is in his apartment overlooking the bold orange hues and shared this sunrise view with us. And Omi in Kmouth is looking out at the ocean, looking so calm today. We'll continue to share those sunrise views from the weekend. We would love to see them. Our number is 063-408-8863.
Thank you so much, Zozo. All set for an amazing weekend. If you want to get out and about, how does the Lito Adventure Festival sound? Well, it's happening in Hearties, and we're going to connect you to a bit of a gig guide, what you can get up to over the weekend. Then a man with a massive role to play every Springbok game, Dion Faree, has put his hand up over and over again. And I think with Malcolm Marks not being there, his skills in and around that loose play, absolutely vital now. We'll take you behind the man in just a moment. We'll continue those amazing profiles of our favourite Springbok players on the other side of us.
my feel good breakfast show.
Welcome back. It is your feel good breakfast show, Espresso on S3, and it's time to plug you with what to do this weekend, our guide to the most amazing experiences across Mzansi that Mzansi has to offer in our little segment called Pick of the Weekend. And this week we are talking to founder and managing director of Lito Experience. Joining all the way from Gauteng is Hloni Pitso. Good morning, Hloni.
Hi, good morning.
Oh, listen, a big weekend ahead. This is now the camp out of the Lito Adventure Weekend at Eagle Waters Wildlife Resort. Why did you decide to host it in Hartbeespoort Dam or Hartbeespoort region this year?
It's actually pronounced Leeto, which means a journey in three South African languages, Sesotho, Setswana, and Sepedi. And yes, Hartis is one of our favorite destinations. As Leeto nomads, we actually travel around the country, and we've decided to choose little dorpies such as Hartis that are full of tourism potential, especially focusing on adventure. So yes, we'll be having the Leeto weekend adventure this weekend, starting today, 29th of September, up until Sunday, 1st of October.
Oh, well, listen, my humble apologies for calling it the Lito. It's the Leeto. Is that better?
That is correct, Leeto.
Now, you mentioned the spectacular scenery. What are some of the incredible activities that attendees can expect this weekend at Leeto?
Okay, so we'll be beginning with a two-hour sunset cruise, a welcome cruise this afternoon from 4 o'clock until 6 o'clock, and that will be followed by a stargazing night picnic. So all campers will be treated by our chefs to an amazing picnic under the stars. And the following day, tomorrow morning, obviously guests will be treated to breakfast, and we'll then begin our adventure activities, which includes zip lining, horse riding, quad biking, boat cruises, and we also have a wellness part to it. We'll be having our instructors that will be conducting a fitness boot camp for 3 hours. So our guests are in for a jam-packed adventure weekend.
Oh, a jam-packed weekend. It sounds what people are looking for, especially with so many water activities. What inspired you to be part of the, as a founding member and managing director of the Leeto Experience? What encouraged you to start it?
Look, I've been in tourism for about 20 years now, and during COVID, one tried to look at what is the world going to look like during COVID time? And the one thing that came up was that people were locked up in their houses. But also what COVID did for us was that it became a springboard for adventure. People are going out hiking, people are going out camping. And we just wanted to be ready to take up that space and have the perfect offering for the enthusiasts that are outdoors.
Oh, so exciting. Now, are there any tickets available? Can people still get passes for the weekend to be part of the Leeto experience? Or are there maybe some giveaways where people can win tickets?
Yes, tickets are open for day visitors as well as for campers. We are on Howler. Once you go on the Howler website, you can then type in Leeto, and the program will pop up, and you'll see all the experiences. You'll see the weekend passes as well as the daily passes, and you're still open to purchase tickets.
Oh, well, Hloni, thank you so much for joining us, and all the best for this weekend.
Well, thank you very much, and thank you to SABC3 as well as Espresso for this opportunity, and we look forward to a very adventurous weekend with our guests.
It is going to be an adventurous weekend, the Leeto Experience. Day passes are still available, and as always, we want to connect with you. So let us know what you are getting up to this weekend, perhaps the next month. You are always welcome to tag us on our social media platforms. That's at Espresso Show, or simply WhatsApp us on this number, 063-408-8863.
Oh, thank you so much. So go out there and enjoy your weekend. Just make sure that you're wrapped up by 8:30 on Sunday evening when the box play. Of course, we've had an opportunity to get behind these incredible players on a different level with the Rugby World Cup. And one player who has a massive amount on his shoulders now is Dion André Fourie, a rugby force from South Africa who shines in the hooker and loose forward roles. We'll forgive him one skew line-out throw-in, okay? Renowned for his relentless ruck prowess, he really has up Raptors game there, he's etched his name in rugby history as the oldest Springbok debutant. We love the sound of that. So join us as we take a closer look at the remarkable journey culminating in the 2023 Rugby World Cup squad in France. I have a feeling he's got a role to play. From Western Province to Lyon and back, this story is amazing. Dion Fury, we love this guy.
Yeah. Absolutely amazing. And we've seen how he plays. I love the fact that he came back to Cape Town, though.
Yeah.
Because he just brings that sense of leadership in the team.
And tenacity. Yeah. He plays with kind of a youthful exuberance that would most put most of the youth out there to shame. But it all had to begin somewhere. And his remarkable journey in rugby culminated in an extraordinary feat, becoming the oldest Springbok debutant on the 9th of July in 2022. Even as I'm saying it, it sounds amazing. I feel like I've been talking about him for so long. Well, it was at 35 years old, 9 months and 14 days young, to be exact. And he rose from the bench at Toyota Stadium in Bloem to become Springbok number 926. And I think his dedication has certainly earned him a ton of fans. He's versatile on the field, so we know he can play hooker, and we kind of need him now. He's a loose forward, and he also played a very rare blend of versatility and adaptability. He can kind of slot in so many different spaces, possibly harking back to his sevens days. Exceptional work rate, and he is over that ball. He is going to need all of those skills right now because he is going to be thrust back into that hooker position. We know that now. And we know that we're going to need him over the ball like we'd need Malcolm to be chasing after those particular balls. He's going to have to run. He's going to have to tackle. This is his time to shine. And it kind of follows his arc. Yes. And now would be his time, being the oldest player.
Yeah, no, definitely. When other players are retiring, he's making his
debut. Getting better.
And he's getting better. He's aging like fine wine, if I can put it, you know, simply like that. And he's absolutely amazing. And, you know, when other players watch the likes of Malcolm Marx over the ball, you know, now you've got Malcolm Marx 2.0. Someone that comes in, he's a typical bulldog on the rugby field.
He's got the low center of gravity. Strong.
And that scrum as well, because now players need to adjust themselves in the opposition to go lower. So they've now adjusted him with the shorter props.
I love it, man. And it does give them options. And this is where you begin to understand this whole bomb squad notion hasn't been quite as risky or crazy as we thought. The game needs the forwards. The game needs the tight five. Yeah. Without them, you can't play. A backline player, I hate to say it, as much as I love the fact that they get to shine, you can take one off and the play
can continue.
You know what I'm saying? But just in the structure. So I get how important it is to have these guys that can blend. How important is it? He spent time in France. He spent a lot of time in the Northern Hemisphere, but he chose to come back to Western Province, where he's played a major role in their Currie Cup glory, of course. How important is it, these players that have chosen to come back, how much did his game improve playing Northern Hemisphere rugby, and how important is that for the Springboks right
now? Unbelievable experience that he's gained, especially with the World Cup. So he's kind of played it in the right direction.
Perfectly.
You know, he played it perfectly in the right direction. And he knows the structures that they have in France and in the Northern Hemisphere. But then he also comes with that versatility of playing sevens. So I'm thinking, are we going to do what everyone's been saying about Quagga and putting him in the back line? Should he And that's the nice thing about how the game is moving in a high-performance way, is the fact that players are becoming so versatile, they could play not just one or two, but three positions now.
I love it. And who do we thank? Seven rugby, baby. I think the fact that a lot of these guys have that grounding, that free-flowing kind of open play defensive mindset, that's how the Springboks play.
Adds to it.
Absolutely beautiful, buddy. Oh, you've done so well with us. We love Dion so much. I think we need a little treat, a premium treat. In fact, I want you guys to get ready to discover, I love it, the new Lindt Lindor 337-gram rugby sleeve. Yep, you can get one for the game right now, or get a few. In fact, it's a treat that's sure to help you score big as you entertain your friends and family while enjoying the Rugby World Cup this weekend. It gets a little bougie with this when you whip out the Lindt at a braai. And whether you're a diehard rugby fan or just looking to satisfy that sweet tooth, that craving, which is starting to happen now that I'm talking about it, you can join us as we combine the excitement of sport, a Rugby World Cup moment, with the irresistibly smooth taste of Lindor. And we love him. And summer is well on its way, and these will make the perfect braai dessert. You can get creative with them, put them in a wrap, in a smoky, you can do whatever you want. But they are premium, and they are amazing, and they're available in the milk and, of course, all of the assorted flavors. If I had to bring out one of our rugby sleeve-adorned Lindors, what would be your favorite?
Milk, the plain.
Really?
Yeah, I just, I love it.
You were waiting to tell me that before I'd finished the question, man.
I was like, come on, bring it on. Where is it?
They are here somewhere. They keep moving them away from us and hiding them. I'm dark chocolate all the way, but I like the sound of an assortment.
Ooh.
So you can go on a little journey. And here's the thing, you can play a game. Every time one of your players scores a try, you get one of the chocolates and vice versa. It's great. And if you'd like to create a moment of bliss at your next Rugby World Cup viewing party, Lint is giving you the chance to win a Lint hamper valued at 1,000 rand. Then you can have every flavor. To enter, head over to our Facebook page or our Instagram page, and then let us know which Lint product will you be eating during the next Rugby World Cup match. And it better have a sleeve on it. Don't forget to include hashtag Rugby with Lint, and those terms and conditions can be found on our expressoshow.com website. I better stop talking about this because my mouth is watering a little bit too much now. We will get to eat, I promise you. We will.
Oh, you both... both of you gents deserve to enjoy some Lindor. Maybe we'll squeeze some chocolates and sneak it in there for you. But coming up after the break, we're going to continue talking rugby action, and then we want to get the braai going. How does a braai broccoli salad sound? I have never done broccoli on the braai, so stay tuned. We'll show you exactly how to do that.
Crouch, touch, but don't you dare pause. Because when you buy any of our favorite Clover products, keep the till slip handy and catch the Expresso Breakfast Show every weekday morning for more details on how to enter. While the Bucks are battling for rugby's greatest prize, you can win your share of 80,000 rands worth of Weber Braais. So engage and win with rugby's greatest moments, brought to you with love by Clover.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
Welcome back. It's a Rugby World Cup happening all around us. Well, pretty close. And, of course, we have one responsibility, making sure that you know what's coming is that responsibility. And we're about to dish out this weekend's Rugby World Cup fixtures, brought to you by the proud sponsors of the 2023 Rugby World Cup. Total Energies, giving you the latest news. So we're plugging to the source. We've got our sports producer Lorenzo Durris joining us again to talk us through some interesting matchups. It's that time of the World Cup where hearts are broken, where we start to believe. We just let that little seed of hope germinate. Hang on a minute, we could just do it. We might make it into the knockout stages. But there are some mouth-watering fixtures, and I think tonight's is ideal. We enjoy New Zealand and Italy going head-to-head. This is going to be a fantastic one because this Italian side almost don't know that they shouldn't be as good as they are. Yeah. They've just got that kind of belief system and belief in themselves, which is great. New Zealand have a massive point to prove, and they've got to kind of do it now.
Yes.
They can't play around anymore. They've got to get it right. So I fear for Italy this evening.
Yeah, I fear for Italy as well. The All Blacks are going to come out ruthless, you know, out on that field tonight. They've got a point to prove, and I think they're also going to go for the point difference because little birdie told me, if I may, that the French will look at...
It's the Kiwi. It's just
ran just like... Lorenzo! And the French might be, you know, putting forward a weakened team like they did against Uruguay a few weeks back. And this would then allow Italy to capitalize to make it through.
They've got to manage their squad now that they've lost so many players. You know, might call it a weakened side. It might be the only side that they can play at this point.
There you go. That's the other thing.
That might be all they're left with. Interesting stuff. So New Zealand might smell blood in the water, and that makes me even more terrified for Italy. But, hey, this Italian side have shown their mettle as well. Then tomorrow, nothing short of spectacular. We've got Argentina and Chile kicking off at 3 p.m., then the clash between Fiji and Georgia, which will be, I think, very physical and very spirited. That kicks off at 6:15 in the evening. And then Scotland and Romania go head-to-head. Fiji's style of rugby, so much has been spoken about the way that they play. They've obviously brought everything great from sevens into this.
Yeah.
But on the backbone of a very solid set piece, solid line-outs, great individual performances, this is their time to shine.
Definitely. Absolutely. The Fijians have taken what they've done in sevens and they've just cut and paste into the 15s, and they tend to just appear when it's the World Cup.
Yeah.
During the years building up to it, we kind of worried about Fiji all the time, and we're pushing for that Pacific Nations team, like we see with West Indies.
For sure,
We've been wanting to see that for years. But I think Fiji is showing, guys, we'd like the investment. Let us be a tier one nation. We have to be a tier
one. Our island is okay without you. Yeah, we don't need everybody. We got ourselves. I love that, man. I think they've won the hearts. They're like this year's Japan. You know, like when you get that team that just wins people over because of the way that they play. Absolutely love that. Scotland, Romania. You would imagine Romania are going to take it this time. The Scottish team. Do they have the potential to score 50, 60, 70, 100? How do you see this one playing out?
Yeah, I don't think that they'll be able to score more than 60 points. I'm being lenient on that, though. I think Duan van der Merwe is going to probably get a nice, you know, hat-trick there.
Yeah.
He's been on fire. So, Pierre Schoeman, them all coming out, and a lot of Saffers in the team.
I was going to say, are you mentioring any actual Scottish people?
And they are Scottish nationally. So
We jest. Yeah.
So the thing is, I think Scotland will win this. They've got the heart. They've got the power. We've seen what they can do in Six Nations and what they've done to us in the Rugby World Cup as well. So I'm thinking between 40 and 55.
Sure, and they need those points.
Yeah.
Australia will take on Portugal. They'll get their win.
You think
finally.
So?
Maybe not. But how do you, as an Australian player, set aside all of this nonsense that's going on around them and actually start and play against any other team you would fear against Portugal? Not so much.
Yeah, not so much against Portugal. But if you look at the heart and soul of Portugal when they played against Georgia, 18-all draw. Georgia is an absolutely amazing team.
Yeah.
Georgia's pushing up. I watched the under-20s when they were here in South Africa as well. Heart and soul of their nation. They play it with their hearts on their sleeve, their chest, everywhere.
Completely,
put it like that. What's happening in Australia at the moment is that they're believing their coach that he's not going to Japan. However, everyone's saying that it has happened. They've got full support in him, and he's got full support in them. I think that we might just see an upset because of what's happening in their camp. I want an upset.
Yeah, it'll either be a big shock. They'll either rally or we'll see that. So that one we'll have to wait and see. Springboks up against Tonga.
Yeah.
I suppose the big question here is not if we're going to lose to Tonga because we should comfortably beat them, but what sort of team are we going to play now in our squad management, player management journey?
Yeah. We firstly need to look at Tonga back in 2007 when we won the World Cup in France. They were quite physical. Schalkburger, them were like, how are we playing against these guys? How are we winning?
Yeah.
Because we almost lost that match.
They'll break your
They will come out again with this game this weekend, and they'll be very physical. And I think that's what Dan Newman was also coming out about, the scrummaging and our forward pack needing to be or test their physicality and take it to them before they take it to us. So we need to intimidate them before they intimidate us on the field.
Is this going to become the Andre Pollard story, yes or no?
Yes, it is going to. The first ball, the first kick that he's going for, we're going to hear thunderstorms coming out of South Africa. If he misses that kick, everyone is going to be eating tables.
And then Marnie will be the only person who goes, Sham, I know Marnie is connected to the bigger picture as much as anyone else on this team. They're willing to do whatever it takes to get us across the line. And I say 60 million of us need to do it. So here's the thing. As your incentive is one of the 60 million, along with the rest of us, you stand a chance of winning 500,000 rand. Wow, your share could be headed your way if you predict the winner of the 2023 Rugby World Cup when you spend 700 rand or more at a participating Total Energy service station. Simply sign up as a Total Energy's club member. That opens the door to such an amazing range of possibilities and rewards. Then you scan your QR code to enter, and then non-Total Energy club members as well. That's how you do it. You just scan your QR code and register to enter on WhatsApp 0723717026. And that competition closes obviously on the 15th of October, right about when the World Cup ends. So just make sure that you get on it now. We're going to have a lot of entries for this one. Good luck.
Just like in rugby, it's uniting our energies that helps us move forward.
Well, ladies, and I suppose I can say gents as well, our razors are bound to go through a fair amount of wear and tear, but it's up to us to increase the lifespan of our razors and razor blades. Now, we can also do this by keeping them clean and storing them properly. Now, I have a few tips that I'd love to share with you on how to keep your big Solel in top-notch condition. Now, my first tip for you is to avoid tapping the razor against hard surfaces. This will damage the blade and other parts of your razor. I know it's so easy. You want to get all that gunk off and you always tap it on the side of the bath. Don't do that. Then tip number two is rinse your razor and blade with hot water after each shave. Another tip is to store it upright in a cool place and a dry place. And if it comes with a holder, make use of it and store it in the holder. And another tip is to replace your razor blades every 5 to 8 shaves. So there you have it. You can now clean and store your razors properly to increase its lifespan and to get smooth looking skin. And remember to always choose soft with Big Solel Click 3 or the Click 3 Sensitive, enriched with aloe vera for the silkiest results. I mean, look at all of these incredible razors. We've got the Click 3, the Click 3 Sensitive, there's the Miss Solel, there's also the Bella that we have here. But there are so many great things for you to make sure that you have the silkiest of smooth legs.
Oh, I love it. Thank you so much. So from what we do to the outside to what we put in on the inside, we're going to make the most delicious light braai side. It is a braaied tender stem broccoli and miso salad. It is going to be amazing, something fresh and healthy for the braai. And then, of course, a gift with purpose, an opportunity to do something truly special. We'll connect you to those feelings in just a moment.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
Welcome back. It is your feel-good breakfast show, and you're just in time because to make life more beautiful and leave behind a more beautiful planet, that's the mission that drives the extraordinary brand Clarins. Now, they understand the importance of the future generations, which is why the well-being of children is at the forefront of their mission. Now, here to tell us more about their gift with purpose and how they are making a real impact is Clarins's media specialist, Rachel Jenkins. Good morning. It's so great
morning.
To have you here.
Thank you for having me.
Oh, you know, I love it when brands have these great purposes and ethos. And I know Clarins is one of those brands that cares about people and the planet. Can
yes.
you tell me more about the brand's mission?
Perfect. So you have completely summed it up. Our CSR strategy really is to take care of the people and to take care of the planet. And it really is as simple as that. And we really do focus very closely on looking at local communities and what we can do for local communities. And for us, it starts with women and children. That's our pinnacle, and that really is close to our hearts. So if we're taking care of children, we're actually taking care of all of our futures.
We definitely are, and I love that you guys have partnered with Save the Children. Talk me about this partnership.
Sure, so the partnership started in 2022, and it really was created as a way of having awareness around how do we really get people to understand the real and measurable impact that we can all have against the fight in childhood hunger. So even though this partnership only started last year, we've already seen a significant impact that's been created. So even though it was started, 2022, we have supplied 82,500 meals to children across
sure.
South Africa. We have trained 94 practitioners and principals in healthy nutritional guidelines, as well as the planting of 16 different vegetable gardens. So I think it's already had such a measurable impact. We wanted to build it more and more. So by people getting involved in our Gift with Purpose campaign, which is really what we have summed up as our partnership, our customers are allowing us to go and make a donation to Save the Children to further the support.
I love it. It's a beautiful full circle ecosystem. I mean, you've had that impact in the first year. I'm so excited to see what the partnership between Clarins and Save the Children will bring as we approach its second year.
Me too.
And you mentioned Gift with Purpose, so
yes.
let's talk about it. What is the Gift with Purpose, and how can customers get involved, and what is in it for them, how they can be part of this partnership?
So our Gift with Purpose campaign really is that if people purchase two products, they automatically qualify for this beautiful gift. So what it is you get this lovely sustainable shopper bag, and our customers can then select four travel sizes of their choice. And it is available at select retailers as well as clarins.co.za until the 8th of October.
Okay, so these are some of the travel size
yes.
items that you can choose to put in your very cute shopper bag.
Yes, and we all need one of these.
I mean,
the amount of times I leave my shopping bag.
And it's just convenient. I mean, a laptop can fit in here if you
yeah.
sometimes don't want to be so obvious, hey, I'm carrying a laptop around with me.
No, exactly.
Rachel, I love when it comes to Clarins, it's a brand that a lot of people know and love and trust.
Yes.
And the double serum is one of them. But you now have the double serum light texture. Let's unpack this product and what makes it different. What is the difference with the light texture?
So our light texture was developed quite literally as a lighter version of our iconic double serum. So everybody knows and loves the worldwide bestseller double serum, but we developed the double serum light texture as a way of being able to offer just a lighter, less oily texture. So it's fantastic as we go now into warmer months. Maybe we want a texture that's not as nourishing on the skin. It's fantastic for men. So I don't know if you know this, but men tend to have a more oily skin texture as well as more sensitive skin. So the double serum light texture is fantastic for men. And then lastly, it really is just for people who maybe have more of an oily skin type or a combination skin type and want something that is just less nourishing on the skin.
Oh,
it's phenomenal.
It sounds incredible. I mean, you know,
My fiance keeps stealing my products, so now it's good to know that you can just be like, hey, here's your own. Have your own.
Absolutely. And I think because it's such a beautiful product, it's the one I would recommend for any person who's wanting to qualify for our Gift with Purpose campaign. Double Serum Light Texture all the way.
Oh, well, thank you, Rachel, for joining us today. And thank you for being here to unpack the wonderful partnership between Clarins and Save the Children. And Clarins invests in the beauty of tomorrow. And you can share in this initiative by purchasing two or more products and receive a gift with purpose. Each purchase helps feed a child in need in South Africa. Now you can shop at clarins.co.za and participating retailers. The offer is available until Sunday, the 8th of October, so go and show your support.
Add some sparkle to your Clarins shopper and help feed a child in need. Purchase two Clarins products and receive your shopper with four iconic travel sizes of your choice. Your gift with purpose. Available at clarins.co.za and participating retailers. Clarins, in partnership with Save the Children.
Now, we promised you today is the day for all the braai recipes that you need for the week ahead. In fact, not just the week, the weekend ahead. There's a lot of rugby action, and we thought, why not give you the ultimate braai and do a roasted broccoli salad with a miso Caesar dressing.
Oh, every morning must start with the smell of a braai. I absolutely love it. Very excited for this one. Every braai needs the perfect side, or maybe you just want to take a different lens to look at your main. But we're going to do it with this beautiful broccoli, braaied broccoli and miso salad. Nicole is going to thankfully take us through this. when I saw this recipe, I thought, wow, this is quite bougie for a salad. But when you're going to do something on the braai, it needs to be spectacular. And if you're going to go, if you're going to present just a veggie dish, yeah, even if it's a side, yes, this could be a main, it's got to be spectacular, right?
I feel like if you are going to make all this effort, Graham, you definitely have to go all out. So we've taken, like, us South Africans love a broccoli salad, so we've just taken it to the next level. So I've just char grilled these a little bit with the, I've added a bit of chili flakes on
saw
here.
The little red flakes are brilliant.
Yeah. Just to give it a little bit of a spice to go with our Asian flavors. And Graham, what you're going to get going on for me is that Caesar miso dressing. So traditionally, ooh, it's got anchovies in, which will work really, really well with our broccoli this morning.
Completely. And anchovies, yeah, quite salty as well. It's almost, yeah, a seasoning in itself. It's got such a high salty.
It packs a punch for sure. Mm. So you're going to combine that with a little bit of garlic. You've got the miso paste, of course, there. You can, ooh, get it at any
loving
retailer
it. Okay,
these
so
days.
I'm going to start just mixing it. So we're going to got our lemon juice.
Yeah. We've actually got lime juice there, Graham, just lime, to go with the flavor combination we've got going on here.
And that's quite an Asian kind of component, is having that lime, that freshness.
That fresh lime, yeah. And actually, lemon and broccoli, or any citrus and broccoli, really, really go together. It's like a salt and pepper, egg and bacon kind of combination.
Okay.
So I always say you finish your broccoli off with a squeeze of lemon or lime, and it really makes it pop.
All the anchovies going in.
All the anchovies. You want that salt punch. So I'm just chopping up a little bit of spring onion. Again, beautiful Asian ingredients we got going in the salad, taking that twist on it. And I'm going to pop everything into a bowl. And as you can see, we've got this beautiful slaw.
Oh,
little
nice
bit of beetroot in there. You can use a traditional slaw if you wanted to, but hey, we are going all out.
Yeah, and I think with the Asian vibe, like the slaw is great because it's got crunch, it's got texture. Its mouthfeel is great, and it's also fresh. So, yeah, if you think about it, if you, I'm speaking obviously from a meat eater, I'll generally have a steak on a braai or quite a fatty meat.
Yeah.
Having a salad like this that packs a punch flavor-wise, but that's got the acidity to cut through the fat, that's got the texture to cut through that.
Beautiful.
Kind of, I think this is the perfect combo to have with your fattier meats. Beautiful, I love it.
Yeah, I mean, even if you wanted to stick to the whole theme of things of the food here, Graham, you could even do like a satay chicken skewers.
Ooh.
Or do like a little bit of a Thai dressing on a steak, just to bring it all together.
Some ribbikis done with a little bit of a smoky barbecue,
or
a Korean barbecue.
There we go.
Come on.
Yeah, okay.
We're
glad
winning
we're on
it
the same page.
A little bit of this going in the mix.
So you basically just wanted to emulsify, so
okay,
a little bit more, Graham, little dash more, just enough to coat our salad here. And I've got some cashews, and the cashews are just going to give it that beautiful texture. And I've got a little bit of some red onion here. And just to bring that beautiful creamy texture, I'm going to add some of our clover feta today.
Feta, oh, well done. So this ticks every box. I think this is fine as a main. I think if you are eating along these lines, for whatever your choice, this is the one of the nicest salads I think we've ever made on the show. And it's not just because we're making it on a braai outside, but if you think of the combination of flavors, maybe I just love the fresh Asian vibe.
Yeah.
I like a bit of heat. I like the pop, the crunch. Everything about it says we're outside. It says we're having a braai. It says we're enjoying a summer day. I love it.
But it's also taking like your traditional salads and bringing a whole new take to that and giving it a new spin. Graham, I need your dressing there. It looks absolutely stunning. Look at that.
It smells incredible. Oh. There's a few little bits in there, but
it's because
okay.
If you think it's too little, guys, it's really not, because it packs such a hectic
punch. It goes a very, very long way.
Yeah.
For me, I would recommend this is a great exercise if you're wanting to introduce more veggies, more fresh components into your diet, which we know is vitally important. Mm-hmm. This will feel and taste like a main. So whether you're doing it around the braai or maybe just charring this on a griddle pan or something like that, I'm thinking for my kids to introduce them to these kinds of flavors. This is a fun, colorful, healthy,
super colorful.
Delicious.
I mean, look at that. And you know what? I'm just going to leave it just as there. We're going to top it off because I'm sure this is going to get devoured in a couple of seconds here with the crew.
We might actually have to hide this.
We're going to have to hide it. And then just to be extra bougie, we're going to finish it off with some toasted sesame seeds. And Graham, that is as easy as that.
Okay, well, as the chef, normally I would steal the first bite, but you have earned the right. So please give us a little bite and a taste and let us know how this gorgeous...
I'm going to test your dressing.
...inspired my resolve. And?
Mm.
Well done, my friend. Boom. That's as easy as it is. I would recommend maybe a little bit of tender stem broccoli if you want to change it up. Otherwise, have fun. There are some powerful, beautiful, delicious flavors. It's so fresh. It is so healthy. The textures are amazing. Mm. And that is, I think, without a doubt, the best braai, side, or main we've made on the show in a long time. Well done, Nicole.
Thanks,
boom.
Ma'am.
Beautiful.
Oh, that looks delicious. Who would have thought you could put broccoli on the braai? Now, we all know about Clover's sizzling competition, offering viewers a chance to win Weber's worth a staggering 80,000 Rand. And it's time to unveil the next four lucky winners. Now, we're going to say a big congratulations to Nkabakazi Majija, Bukang Esi Mplahlela, Happy Tabile Nkosi, and Michelle Mtolo. Now, if your name wasn't announced this morning, do not worry, because Clover still have four Weber's to give away. So simply buy any one of their products and keep your till slip handy. Then you dial *120*560# and follow the prompts to enter. It really is that easy. And keep watching your Feel Good Breakfast Show daily to find out more. There are T's and C's that can be found on their website. That's clover.co.za. Well, we are taking a quick break. When we get back, we have the dynamic duo Kasusa in studio, ready to bring you your Friday entertainment. And then we want to give you the opportunity to spin and win big. That is on its way, so stay tuned.
The sun is here, the trees all emerald green, but how do you get your spirits up when spring allergies got you down?
Achoo! It's tough, man. Well, you do it with SetiSit and Espresso's springtime competition. Because this month, you stand to win cash prizes of 5,000 Rand each when you answer the weekly questions on Espresso's Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram pages. And of course, include the all-important hashtag SetiSit in your answer. T's and C's apply.
We promised you a busy show, and yes, it is jam-packed, but get ready because next week marks the beginning of Hopetober. Can you believe we are at the end of September?
I kind of still remember wrapping up last year's Hopetober. I don't understand this, but I'm so happy that it's here. This initiative is, of course, brought to you by one of our proud partners, Adcock Ingram OTC, officially the sponsors of Brave. And it dedicates the entire month of October to spreading hope and kindness throughout South Africa. We love it.
We need it so much. And it's a time for all of us to come together and make a positive impact in our fellow citizens' lives. Even the simplest of gestures, like a friendly wave or a warm greeting, 100%. Can brighten someone's day.
Oh, completely. Just those little moments can add up. So listen up. Because Adcock Ingram OTC, the sponsors of Brave, they have one amazing gesture up their sleeve. They are giving away 1,500 Rand in cash every weekday on Expresso during the entire month of October. Every day, 1-5 has got to go. So make sure that you tune into your favorite breakfast show daily for all of the details and how you can enter and be a part of this incredible journey of hope and, yes, a lot of generosity.
September is Pharmacy Month. In proud association with Adcock Ingram OTC, sponsors of Brave, inspiring communities one pharmacy at a time.
Well, it's time for us to catch up with those national headlines. Let's start off with local news. Johannesburg has suffered a sharp drop in its reputation as a top financial center, falling from position 69 to 83 in the Global Financial Centers Index. Some 121 cities are ranked according to surveys of 147 factors provided by third parties, including the World Bank and the United Nations. The factors include the state of the local business environment, human capital, infrastructure and financial sector development. And staying with our local news, the Constitutional Court has dismissed Julius Malema and the Economic Freedom Fighters, the EFF's application for leave to appeal an interdict preventing them from initiating illegal land grabs. AfriForum acquired the said interdict in 2017, and an appeal brought by Malema and the EFF was previously dismissed by the Pretoria High Court. In the order, the Apex Court concluded that the application should be dismissed as it bears no reasonable prospects of success. The EFF has described the Constitutional Court's dismissal with costs as disappointing and ahistorical. Moving to news abroad, Switzerland's glaciers have lost a further 4% of their volume this year, the second biggest loss ever after last year's record melt of 6%. These statistics are in the annual report of the Swiss Glacier Monitoring Network, which has been monitoring 176 of Switzerland's 1,400 glaciers for years. It warns that it may now be too late to save many of the alpine ice fields, even if climate targets are met. In just 2 years, Switzerland's glaciers have lost 10% of their total volume. And Kenya has pledged to lead a multinational security force in Haiti in response to a plea from the Caribbean National Prime Ministers for help to restore order. Haiti has suffered from gang violence for decades, but the current wave of brutality escalated after the July 2021 assassination of President Jovenel Moïse. Gangs have taken control of large parts of the country, waging terror on residents and killing hundreds. The UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres has said a robust use of force is needed to disarm the gangs and restore order. And her secret to life has always been backed by 5 rules. And as Agnes Besaidenhout celebrated her 102nd birthday last week, these rules are still intact. Live one day at a time, live them to the fullest, live happily and live healthy, and thank the good Lord above. This soul filled with zest for life, Glamour Granny, originally hails from Kimberley but currently resides in Kenilworth, Cape Town, with her youngest of 5 children, 67-year-old Mersha Besaidenhout. Mersha says her mom is a living witness to her favourite saying, on top of the world like a rose on a bush. Agnes, may your 102nd year of life indeed be an extremely blessed one. Well, that's where I leave your morning headlines for now. Let's take another look at your sport.
Let's start with the good news first. And did she not come good yesterday? Laura Volfart played a captain's knock and more yesterday to lead the Proteas women to a 7-wicket victory over New Zealand's ladies, a victory that secured them the series 2-0 in their favour with one game remaining. So Volfart struck 15 fours on her way to her fourth career century with an unbeaten 124 of 141 deliveries that also etched her name in the history books as the first South African women's player to score more than 3 ODI centuries, and I have a feeling there are many more to come. So South Africa chasing down the 254-run target with ease as former captain Sine Lewis added 53 or 57. She carved out a half century, followed by Morazan Cup's unbeaten 45. And that third and final ODI gets underway on Sunday at 9:30 in the morning. Now, not the best news for the gents in the Proteas camp. The Proteas captain, Themba Bavuma, has had to travel back to South Africa from India, citing family reasons for his departure. So consequently, he'll be absent from the Proteas preparations for the Cricket World Cup, missing those two warm-up matches up against Afghanistan and New Zealand. And it's expected in Bavuma's absence that Aidan Markram will take on the role of captain for the games. However, it is anticipated that Bavuma will rejoin the team in time for their World Cup campaign opener against Sri Lanka on the 7th of October in Delhi. And we hope so. He really has played himself into some brilliant form throughout the Australian tour. Now we turn to football, and this is where the stars are born in a thrilling showdown at the 2023 Varsity Football Final held at UJ Soweto Stadium. Defending champions TUT secured their fourth title by triumphing over UJ in a dramatic penalty shootout. So the match had ended one apiece after regular time. Despite the 2023 Golden Boot winner Ronald Mabaso uncharacteristically missing a crucial penalty, TUT then held their nerve in the ensuing penalty shootout to outscore UJ 5-4, thus securing their status as the 2023 Varsity Football Champions for the second consecutive year. Congratulations. And of course, we had one Rugby World Cup match last night, a high-stakes one for the two teams. And Japan, they made significant progress towards the quarterfinals of the World Cup with a 28-22 victory over Samoa, securing England's spot as Pool D winners now based on the point outlay. So tries from Peter Labuschagne, Michael Leitch and Kazuki Himeno, combined with 13 points from fly half Rikia Matsuda, provided a comfortable lead. And they were able to hold on despite a late push from a 14-man Samoa. Japan, they held on. So they're now in second place in the pool with 9 points, setting up what will be a crucial clash with Argentina next week if the Pumas do win their match against Chile, as expected. Then, of course, don't forget you can catch all that action live on SABC2 radio stations and SABC Plus. No subscription fees apply. And Argentina will clash against Chile at 2:30 tomorrow afternoon. And then on Sunday, you can, of course, catch Sia and the lads take on Tonga at 8:30 p.m. It's going to be a great one. Don't miss a second. And that's where we leave our sport for now. The roads should be waking up. We'll be talking about a bit of sports betting in just a moment. But right now, no bets when it comes to the road. Safety first.
We start off with your traffic in Cape Town, Kraaifontein. There's been a truck accident. It's on the N1 inbound at Brighton Road. The road has been reopened, but there are heavy delays this morning. And in Athlone, Cape Town, there's some congestion on the N2 inbound at Jakes Harwal. Expect delays. That's your traffic. Let's take another look at your weather. And the Western Cape Department of Agriculture says preliminary estimates indicate that damage amounting to some 1.4 billion rand was caused in the sector, in fact was lost in the sector by last weekend's heavy rain and flooding. The provincial minister, Ivan Meyer, says there's serious damage in important agricultural regions such as the Cape Winelands, the Overberg, the Garden Route, the Central Karoo and the West Coast. He says damage to infrastructure amounts to an estimated 300 million rand and about 200 million rand's worth of crops were lost. Mayor says this will have an impact on agricultural exports, but not on food security. Meanwhile, the Meringspoort Pass between De Rust and Klaarstroom in the Karoo was reopened to traffic yesterday. A stop-go system applies and it was closed on Monday after heavy flooding. On that note, let's take another look at today's temperatures.
Those are your temperatures for your Friday. Let's take a look at your sunrise views. Dave in Umbilo is up early this morning and shared the sunrise in the distance. Nancy Govender, of course, sharing another beautiful sight at Rocky Bay, about to head down to enjoy a walk on the beach. Ishmael in Pelican Park is heading to work quickly and snap this photo of the sunrise. Sarah from across our borders in Michigan in the US sent this sensational photo overlooking the dam with the sun gently rising in the distance. We'll continue to share those sunrise views with us. Our number is 063-408-8863.
It's a Friday. We need the party to be started. And Kosusa are here to do it. Welcome to the party, boys. They're going to get it started in just a moment. Then lest we forget, it's a big sporting weekend. Let's get a little betting going. Hilton is back to give us some tips on this. And, of course, the impending Cricket World Cup coming up. And then, of course, you might get to spin the World Sports Betting Wheel. We have given away nearly 100,000, probably over 100,000 rand now. You could be the next winner. Stick around. Start practicing that spinning arm.
Crouch, touch, but don't you dare pause. Because when you buy any of our favorite Clover products, keep the till slip handy and catch the Espresso Breakfast Show every weekday morning for more details on how to enter. While the Bucks are battling for rugby's greatest prize, you can win your share of 80,000 rands worth of Weber Braais. So engage and win with rugby's greatest moments, brought to you with love by Clover.
Yes, it's going to be your opportunity to win big a little bit later in the show. But all of us have the opportunity to win big every day when it comes to the Rugby World Cup and other amazing sporting opportunities. Whether you're a diehard sports enthusiast or simply wanting to maybe just enhance your enjoyment of the game, exploring the captivating world of betting and odds can inject a whole nother level, a layer of excitement into your favorite sporting events. And today we welcome back Hilton Hassan, director of World Sports Betting, to unpack this weekend's sports odds report. And of course, there are many permutations just to spice things up. Hilton, so good to have you. How are you, my friend?
Yeah, good.
Are you surviving? Yeah, are you surviving this World Cup?
Yeah, it's been great. It's been great.
It's been absolutely wonderful. Obviously, Ireland coming good against the Springboks, or us not quite clicking with the changes we've made. Has that changed things? What has that done in your world?
You know, South African supporters, you're a defined nation.
Yeah.
No, you beat New Zealand 35-7 in a World Cup warm-up. You're the best team in the world.
Oh, 100%.
You lose Ireland in a crucial World Cup match. It's like, well, it's great. You've got France in the quarterfinals. It can't be the end of the world.
We're glass half full. I love that. We've got the small matter of Tonga this weekend, and I don't want to count them out. You know, we kind of feel like we could definitely get a good score, but we could lose players. They're a very physical team, but all of the talk has to be around Andre Pollard. Does that change things? Does that change our mindset when betting for this particular fixture?
I think it's been more sort of hope than certainty.
Okay.
You know, if you look at his record versus Marnie's record, Marnie's record 67% strike rate. Andre's 73%.
Yeah, 100%.
So it's not like we're comparing Dan Carter with Stevie Wonder. We're comparing sort of apples and apples. The biggest concern is, like you said, Tonga's a physical side. And if you go in underdone, we just don't know how fit he is.
Yeah.
You know he's going to be targeted. So one big hit, and then maybe he's just not going to be up for it. And that's the biggest concern from our side.
Yeah, I'm thinking in terms of releasing these backline players, Marnie is such a big part of that open play fluidity, that Cape style of rugby where, you know, he releases the speedsters around him. But I know, Andre, I've seen him step up to the plate every single moment that he has been given or often forced into. He has stepped up, and he's done it. Oh, I feel like a kid in a candy store because this is the best sporting year ever. We've had all this amazing women's sport. Now we get all these amazing men's competitions. Now we've got the small matter of a Cricket World Cup coming through. Who are you most excited about? Where is the hype around this particular World Cup? If we start getting our betting shoes on for this particular tournament, where are you leaning towards?
Well, it's been a bit low-key with the rugby. But I'll tell you something, you know, if you go into a World Cup, you need momentum.
Yeah, okay.
And coming from 2-0 down against Australia and winning the series 3-2, that's pretty much what the momentum needed. Because I think there was a few doubts about South Africa.
And especially and against an Australian team that's hitting their straps.
Absolutely.
This is a good side.
Absolutely.
Who are the players to watch at this year's Cricket World Cup? And obviously Australia will be a team to watch. England have to be a team to watch as the defending champions.
India, always. Home ground advantage.
For sure.
And we've got an issue now with Themba Bavuma coming home this week. He's going to miss the two warm-up games. You know, how's that going to affect sort of the chemistry of the team?
How's it
going to be
culture,
when he goes back? So, yes, it's not ideal. But, you know, these guys are professionals, and I'm sure they'll step up.
Yeah, we saw Aiden step up during the tour as well. He had an opportunity, and he led from the front there. Absolutely love it. What influences cricket in that sense? I know you talk about players coming into form. We've got some big domestic competitions. When we're looking for the value of a cricketer, when we want to bet for a team or bet for a cricketer, how do you go about assessing the value there, what a good bet is?
I think the most important thing is how players play particular conditions.
Okay.
So you don't go to the subcontinent in India if you can't play spinners.
Okay.
You know, it's that type of thing. And I think track records. You need to go and have actually played in on a venue, played against these players. I mean, you go and play in India. I mean, those crowds are vicious. You
know? And I've heard it's on a different level. 100,000 fans out there gunning for you. It's on a different level. But I love that. Have a little bit of fun. Sink your teeth into some cricket info. Go and look at bios. See who plays well, where, because it will make a difference. Locale is massive in this part of the world. I absolutely love it. And then lastly, we've got the predictor contest action. I think a lot of people might get intimidated by how far you can go in the betting world with permutations and things. You can just take one step and win big. How do we do that?
Yeah, so we've paid out over 1.6 million rand since the beginning of the tournament.
It's
really that easy.
And I'm boasting about our 100 grand on the show. That's amazing.
And it's not even that difficult, Graham. Like we said before the tournament, you just need to log on to the website, click on Rugby Predictor, put in what score you think's going to be the final score, and if you get it right, you can win 30,000 rand.
That is incredible, my man. I'm thinking very much about what that score is going to be. And they have given away a lot of money, and we have given away a lot of money. I laugh about 100 grand, but that's life-changing. Over 100,000 rand has been given away courtesy of Spinning This Wheel. And you, maybe you, sitting right there listening to us right now, will have that opportunity. Oh, good luck. Hilton, thank you, my brother.
Cheers, girl.
Well, it's time for some entertainment, and we are joined by Kususa, DJ and producer duo Kunzima and Samurai, originating from Durban, and they are award-nominated South African dance music duo with a dark and edgy Afrotech Afro House sound with the hit single Asanda alongside Zakes Bantwini. Can we give them a good feel-good welcome? Good morning. I love that the two of you are up early. You're so happy to be here, although I know you normally go to bed late, right?
Yes. It's usually like 9 a.m., 10. So.
This is, you're still half asleep, but we are ready to hear you perform. I'm going to start off with you, okay. Samurai. Tell me the collaboration that took place between the two of you. When did you decide, hang on, we could make a very dynamic duo?
So we started doing remixes together back in 2016. And then, like, the remixes started working out. So we had, like, two or three, and then we had, like, other DJs playing the songs. And then from there, we're like, okay, it works. Yeah, and then, yeah, it started from there, actually.
Amazing. And how do you find this dynamic partnership between the two of you?
Actually, it's very good, strong one, because when we first met, when we had a chat, we obviously had, like, same goals when it comes to music and everything. So by having the same goals, I think we on the same track, same direction towards, like, everything we want. Yeah.
And same ambitions as well, which also just makes that trajectory so much stronger and faster. Mm-hmm. Now, I love that you have collaborated with your EP, Ubomi, and you collaborated with Argento Dust. What was that partnership like for you?
So with Argento, we own a label, so it's called Black Noise Music Africa. So we met through that, and then we started just collaborating on the EP, working towards an album. So yeah, it's been great. Like past 3 years, the label's still young, and yeah, it's doing great.
Oh, well, listen, we are so excited that both of you have joined us today. I know it's a lot brighter than what you used to. You like the darker lights, but it's okay. Because right here on your Feel Good Breakfast Show, we have Kususa. They are ready to perform their track, Asunder. Take it away.
Manga, go back.
Add some sparkle to your Clarins shopper and help feed a child in need. Purchase two Clarins products and receive your shopper with four iconic travel sizes of your choice. Your gift with purpose. Available at clarins.co.za and participating retailers. Clarins, in partnership with Save the Children. It's my feel good
breakfast show. I don't know what I'm doing, putting myself up against Zoe, but it's time for a little bit of a competition, and we are here for that. You know what your favorite groceries are, but do you know how much they cost? This game always surprises us. It's time to find out in another round of Guess the Price. Dun, dun, dun. Today, it's random, okay? So we have worked off rough averages, so please don't come after us if you can find it cheaper somewhere else, okay? We have gone to a variety of stores, and this one, this game really does speak to who does the shopping. Do you do the shopping? Does Robbie do the shopping? Do you do it together?
During the week, pretty much it's just easier if I do it. Weekends we do it together, but
I think when you shop on weekends, you don't really, because everyone's got their own list and you just put everything in the trolley. But when you shop alone, you actually get a shock. You're like,
oh, wow, you're adding it up. Yeah, for sure. You got the cell phone calculator out. You go, oh, wow. Okay, so we're going to do it. I'm going to go head to head with Zozo and we're going to see if we know how much these various items cost. So let's start with, Coke. We got the No Sugar Buddy Bottle, the 500 ml.
Oh, I grab these often when I go, so $13.99.
Okay, I was going to go a bit more. Well, I'm going to say 15 rand, but I feel like you already know this because you are... Okay. Ha-ha, you see. Okay. She's going to think about where she's shopping now. well done, Mia. One under the belt. 15 freezer bags, small. Oh, my...
$49.99.
Okay, that was very confident. I feel like I shouldn't even answer now. I would say, yeah, I'll go with 39. Let's see, $49.99. Did you literally just buy small freezer bags?
No, I was just very shocked at how much it cost for 15.
It is, it's a thing. Okay, one a piece. Romani creams, I actually haven't bought these in a while.
I haven't bought biscuits in a while.
$38.99.
I was gonna go, I think I should go
36.99. I think I was just like a cent closer to that. Not bad. Those are still pretty reasonable. Okay. We're still neck and neck. Oh, there we thank you for giving us that one. Paper stem buds refill, I'm not even going to ask. It's $19.99, Zoe, because I have no
idea. Oh, it's there. It's right there. Okay. They didn't allow us to.
I knew that would have been a conundrum for both of us. All right. Let's bring up some less sodium soy sauce.
How much does soy sauce cost? Is that like 70 bucks, 69?
Yeah,
99?
I was thinking in the region of 80. I'm going to go 85.
$74.99.
85. Come on. $97.99. It's because they've taken the salt. They've taken something out, so it must cost more.
And it just tastes better if the sodium's in there.
Oh, come on.
The red one is just better.
Well, look, it's a healthy option, okay? People are going to be considering their healthy options from now on. Ooh, this one is...
Macaroni pasta.
Gee whiz, I haven't bought a pasta in a while.
I'm going to guess $49.99.
$36.99. It's always got to be that.
$40.
Come on, $22.99.
We need to eat more pasta.
Hey, the humble macaroni still delivering. I absolutely love the fact that I think I have won that. I think I might just have edged you. Yeah.
No more to get.
We're not going to go to... Oh, there's one more, Zoe. You can do it. Doom insect spray. I haven't bought this in an eon.
$47.99.
You're so confident. yeah, I don't know. 39. 39 rand 99. 45.
I was closest.
Closest. We'll call it a draw. Well done. it is always surprising. Some things a little bit cheaper, some things a lot more. It's always, we are hoping that you are going to do this exercise yourself. And of course, this game really does remind you to be conscious of the prices because we know they are constantly changing, rising, occasionally falling, but generally rising. So to help you save on your groceries, sign up for a Nedbank My Goals account so that you can get cash back on those purchases, your entire purchase, no matter where you shop, in fact. And to find out about this awesome account and all of the other perks on offer, there's some great rewards. You can visit Nedbank's Money app. Really go and check it out.
Check this. This My Goals Plus account gives you cash back on groceries and 25 cents back per litre at DP. That's lit.
Lit in 2023. I wonder.
We asked Hilton to stick around so you can feel the nerves we all go through when you spin this wheel. It's your opportunity to win. All right, prepare for an adrenaline-fueled adventure with World Sports Betting, where victory is just a heartbeat and possibly just a spin away. A whopping total of 96,000 rand, 554 rand, in fact, added to that to be exact, has been given away over this past month alone. It's time now to see what this week's lucky spinner is going to walk away with. So we asked you guys to tell us what MMA stands for in the context of combat sports. And Jamie Lee Roberts was on the money, answered mixed martial arts, hashtag world sports betting. So not only was she randomly selected as the week's lucky winner, but she also got the answer right. So well done, that bodes well. We've got Jamie on the line right now. A very good morning, Jamie.
Hi.
Hi, you sound a little bit nervous, which is perfectly right. You must be, because you could be winning something big. Your moment has arrived. We've got the big shots here for you. Hilton from World Sports Betting has stuck around so he can get a little taste of the magic, okay? But here's the deal. Jamie, we need you to give Hilton this instruction. Do you want a nice, firm, hard spin? Do you want something a bit more gentle? What is your heart telling you? What's the vibe?
I think you should spin a bit by God.
Okay, so give it some chias, Hilton. Give it a bit of chias. Now, he's as nervous as I am because we know how much has been given away already. So, Jamie, you're going to have to do the countdown for us. Can you give us a 3, 2, 1, spin the wheel? Go for it.
3, 2, 1, spin the wheel.
Go for it. Oh, you put some muscle in there. Put a bit of meat in there. Look, there are no small amounts here. There is money everywhere on this table, but you just happen to land on the big one! 10,000 rand from Jamboree! I knew it! I knew it! Congratulations! Jamie, you've just won yourself 10,000 rand! That is amazing! This wheel is amazing! Now, here's the big question. Are you currently a World Sports Betting account holder?
Yes, I am, actually.
Oh, we get to say right now a double congratulations, because that 10,000 rand is now going to be met with 10,000 rands worth of vouchers for you to go and spend on World Sports Betting. That's 20,000 rand with the opportunity to win a whole lot more. Can we get a round of applause? Jamie, congratulations! Oh, my word. I wouldn't know what to say right now, but I'm going to put it on you anyway. How do you feel right now?
I'm so excited. I can't wait to spend it.
I cannot wait to see what you're going to spend it on. What's the big thing? What do you want to go out there and get? Who do you want to spend the money on? Why are you so excited?
I think I'll be taking my mother out, and I'll be buying myself a birthday present.
Oh, man, I love it. Spend some money on yourself. Spend it on the people that you love. Put a little away. You do whatever you want and make sure you get on those World Sports Betting vouchers quickly, because you have an opportunity to win even more. Congratulations. So don't forget, World Sports Betting is opening the door for one fortunate viewer to spin this wheel for victory on Espresso every Friday morning over the coming weeks. And to secure your chance in next Friday's spin, that's the 6th of October, head over to the competition post on our Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram pages and tell us this. If you could play any sport, what would it be and why? And don't forget, hashtag World Sports Betting in that answer. The competition closes on the 2nd of October, midday. That's Monday. You can find the terms and conditions on espressoshow.com. Hilton, after that spin, we might have to bring you back. Thanks, my friend. Congratulations. Jamie, well done. I cannot believe we've maxed out with almost every spin of this wheel. Congratulations, Jamie, our latest winner, spinning the World Sports Betting Wheel.
Oh, well, listen, we are taking a quick break on your Feel Good Breakfast Show. We've got a bit of a dance battle going on. Super M flavors versusing each other. Versusing, that's now a new word. And then we are getting ready for more braai action. Chef Clem is standing by, and we've got another delicious recipe to share with you.
Summer too hot, it's irregular. It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Welcome back. If you're wondering what's going on out here, it's about to make sense. There is an epic battle raging online right now, and I feel like we kind of started it. Super M has two brand new limited edition flavors. Just look at them. And they're about to go head to head. It's peanut butter versus energy. And you get to vote for your winner and taste a whole lot of Super M trying to make up your mind. So go out, taste these awesome new flavors for yourself and vote for your favorites on the Super M social pages using hashtag Super M. And that limited edition might just become a permanent favorite. So now, to bring our characters to life, Super M has launched an exciting comic series that follows their journey as they enter the Super M Academy. This week in episode 2, it's all about who has the best moves. Take a look at this.
It's the battle of the flavors at the Super M Academy. Energy versus peanut butter.
Yo.
Who is worthy? Try new Super M and vote.
Who is worthy indeed? We will find out today. The stage has been set, and now we have a very special treat for you. Just an added bonus. It's time for a little dance battle in studio. We've invited our dance crew today from Dance Sport Club League of the Western Cape. They're amazing, and we've split them down the middle into two incredible teams, Energy and Peanut Butter. You can tell by the colors. And we'll be live streaming the action right now on our Expresso Facebook and Instagram pages as well, where you can vote for your favorite. And here is it, how it's gonna be broken down. One team gets 30 seconds to show their stuff, then the other team responds. Battle lasts for 2 rounds, so each team gets 2 30-second slots to break it down. Who decides to go first? Well, I might decide. Make sure you vote for your favorite crew now on our social pages. We'll be announcing the winner a little bit later on the show today. So all the best of luck to Team Energy and Team Peanut Butter. You can kick it off. It's a dance battle, baby. Not bad. Okay. It's over. And I have a feeling they're going to keep dancing. Well done. Was it Team Peanut Butter? What is a Team Energy? There's a lot of fire here. There's a lot of crackle in the studio. You get to vote. You get to add to the excitement, and this is your chance to win as well. How cool is this? If you reply to the competition question on our Expresso Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram page and tell us which new Super M flavor is your favorite and why you love it, so do a couple of taste tests. Of course, don't forget that hashtag Super M. The competition closes on the 1st of October at midnight, but you can find those terms and conditions on expressoshow.com. Who took it today? Let us know. Give them a big round of applause. It's Team Energy. It's Team Peanut Butter, baby. Woo. It's tense, man. Ahead of the weekend, we are having a little bit of fun around the braai, looking at things differently, maybe like a side, like our beautiful salad that we made earlier. How about a dessert right now? And this one is as South African as it can be. It's a milk tart jaffle. Take it away.
Thank you, G-Man. Well, listen, I'm so excited. It's my turn to enjoy the braai. And Chef Clem, he is here, and we're about to make the ultimate jaffle. And I'm not talking about any jaffle. I'm talking about a milk tart jaffle. Chef Clem, is this breakfast or is this dessert?
This falls under the anytime
meal
category. Yeah, absolutely. I mean, it is so delicious, so toasty, so smoky. It should just be for absolutely any time.
Now, for people that don't know what a jaffle is, it's that cute little machine that you squish your bread in. Mm-hmm. And I normally know, my mom would make jaffles with mince.
She would make
jaffles with cheese. Mm-hmm. So what is your go-to jaffle? Because this is the first time I'm about to make a milk tart-inspired one.
I'm with your mom. My go-to is always the mince, the savory mince jaffle. Crowd pleaser. Mm-hmm. I've not done a lot of sweet jaffles. We've done a few with the s'mores, but this is the first time I'm doing milk tart jaffle.
Okay.
I tasted it. It's really good.
Well, I'm excited to taste it.
Let's do this. And it's so easy to make. So what you're going to do is we're going to get a poiky pot. Let me get that on the heat. There we go.
And I love that we are using our Weber for this. You can control the temperatures. Is this going to be one of those lid on, lid off situations?
No, it's lid off. You can kind of, it's stirring motion, so you want the lid off. In the bowl, we've got one egg. We're going to go first with some vanilla.
Ooh.
You need the vanilla in there.
You do need the vanilla.
You need cinnamon. You can add more cinnamon, eh? You can go, like, depending on your cinnamon, like, threshold, you can go full-on cinnamon.
I have to tell you, so I went for breakfast, and, you know, they serve you your bowl of oats, and the lady thought she was doing me a favour by putting the cinnamon in a row, and it looked pretty, but it was just too much cinnamon. Like, I know she had every intention to make it look nice, but I was like, too much cinnamon.
Did you do the cinnamon cough? No. I love to see that.
But we have just the right amount of cinnamon.
There we go, just the right amount. Corn flour goes in, and that is, along with the flour, will actually thicken our milk tart filling, because you want this quite thick.
Oh, you want it to be creamy.
You want it to be creamy. So give that a mix. Once it all comes together, that's when I like going in with the milk, because I don't want to have any lumps or bumps of the flour and corn flour in the mixture.
Should I mix for you and then you add the milk and it's a team effort?
I like that this is actually a one-man job, but we're just doing this for the sake of teamwork. Here we go with the milk. Nice.
See, I don't have the chef arm.
You do, you're doing the things. There we go.
No, my arm's tired.
Okay, in we go.
I don't know how you guys whisk for as long as you do.
You have to. Okay, I'm ready for you. So, into our poiky pot now that's nice and warm. We're going to treat this like a custard, because essentially that's what it is.
We are making the custard.
So in it goes into our pot, and you are going to give it a good mix, and it's going to start thickening up really quickly.
What do you do if your coals are too hot in a moment like this?
You grab a lappie. Uh-huh. And then you lift up your poiki.
Okay.
And then you do a air stir.
So you can control the heat.
You really
can. That's not an excuse.
And you should. So what I also like doing on my Weber is I like stacking most of the coals on one side.
Okay.
And leaving some empty space on the other side, because then it's like a hot and medium like you normally have in a stove, and it's what you've done now with your Weber. So
look, it's already.
Yes, because I wasn't paying attention. So it actually comes together very quickly.
Would you say we don't want the lumps, but it lumps quite quickly, so you want to continuously stir?
The lumps are good. The lumps are letting you know that it's coming, it's setting. So if it does set and then you have a few extra lumps, take your whisk and just whisk it out. And then it'll be nice and smooth. So I'm going to put this in the back because I don't want it to get too lumpy.
Because we have a finished
custard
here. And we want that. That's the consistency you're looking
for. It's got to have a jiggle.
A jiggle.
Okay? That's
jiggle,
good. Jiggle. You want that jiggle. So what you're going to do is you're going to butter the bread, but now imagine, imagine I've buttered the bread, okay? I don't want to break the bread. The butter's a bit hot.
Without butter, right?
Totally,
if you want to watch the calories all of a sudden.
You can.
Not that it's going to add much.
The more you use your jaffle iron, the more nonstick it becomes, and then you don't really need butter.
Okay.
So, yeah, perfect. So, cool.
To do
what? While you do the one to breaky. I'm going to put that together, give it a little squish. And I like keeping most of that filling in the center because, you know, the jaffle iron kind of squishes
it out.
So let me just get this one out real quick. I mean, look how beautiful that is.
That is a beautiful jaffle.
It's a little caught on the side, but you know what? That is absolutely fochias.
Chef Clem, let's take that one out. Oh, you can see you've got chef fingers. Nothing burns.
There we go. And you're going to hit it with some more cinnamon sugar while it's still hot.
And can I cut it open?
Oh, please do.
I'm going to cut it open so that you can see this beautiful jaffle that just came hot out of the oven. I say oven, hot off the fire. And look at that.
Oh, yes.
And then Be careful, that custard is hot.
I'm going to hit it with a little bit of cinnamon sugar while you're busy. Yes. These are so delicious. They smell amazing. And I think because they cook so quickly and because you can make the filling in advance, then they really should be made as a bride dessert. And I love desserts on the bride.
This is a bride dessert. I'm going to take one of the ones that you guys made earlier. This is beautiful.
Who smak hy? Who feel Engels?
Ek proe so lekker.
Who feel Engels kry?
Hy kry al die Engels in die hemel.
All the Engels. Graham, all the Engels. Yeah, that is a...
G-Man, I'll bring some back to studio just for you. If you want to get your hands on this delicious recipe that Chef Clem made on our Weber, head on over to our website, expressoshow.com. This is good.
Oh, my word. Well, it is feeling like a party already. The weekend has officially begun, and Kusasa, they are going to take us to the next level with some absolute bangers on the way in just a moment. Then we couldn't be more proud of our connections to the SAFTAs this weekend. And, of course, hosting it, Sozibini Tunzi, is stepping into a different role, but I think she's going to kill this one like she does absolutely everything else. We'll link live with her in just a moment.
Crouch, touch, but don't you dare pause. Because when you buy any of our favorite Clover products, keep the till slip handy and catch the Expresso Breakfast Show every weekday morning for more details on how to enter. While the Bucks are battling for rugby's greatest prize, you can win your share of 80,000 rands worth of Weber Braais. So engage and win with rugby's greatest moments brought to you with love by Clover.
It's my feel-good breakfast show. Welcome back. We're back on our espresso stage with the amazing, talented DJs and good mates, producer duo Kunzima Theology and Samurai Yasusa.
Yeah.
We love the fact that you guys have brought these bangers at this time of the day. I know for a DJ, this is not your happy hunting ground, unless you've already played for 3 days straight and you're coming back into the space. But it does beg the question, guys, with your kind of music, because there is such an eclectic mix. There are so many different influences coming in. And now with the two of you working together, it's going to be even more. How do you build a set? How do you go about preparing? Because people have an expectation now when they get a set from you guys. How do you go about crafting that catalogue of songs for a big night out? Where does your mind start?
So basically, we DJs first. So the basic instincts will be reading the crowd, knowing the crowd, feeling the vibe. And obviously, if you've been following us, we have like a following, so people appreciate our music. So we play along those lines with what fits with our music.
And when you say like you have a following, I think you're underselling it now. You guys you've started something special, and you're starting to play on some pretty big stages. When a crowd responds to your music in that way, when you're thinking about the set, the pressures, the everything else, there's got to be a moment in a set where the crowd is feeding off that, where they are literally giving your music back to you. How good does that feel?
And actually, like, feels great for us, because at our start, being a bedroom producer, bedroom DJ,
we
obviously have, like, visions and, like, imagination.
But it's all in the head.
And you want to witness, like, that moment, like, in front of the people, big stage, everything. So it's really massive excitement for us.
Yeah. When you guys started flowing together in this space, because it looks like you're feeding from the same brain, like left hemisphere, right hemisphere, or something like that. When you guys are playing and performing, and I know you prepare a lot before doing a set, so you've got a clear idea what's going to happen, but once you go live, baby, everything changes.
Different.
What is that chemistry between the two of you like in that space?
I think we've been playing together for like 7 years now. So we've built like the chemistry, and you know, we love the same music, you know, so it's just natural
for us. We simply understand each other, so it's easy for me to blend them.
Yeah, so he kind of just knows.
And it's like, I find it with a lot of our colleagues, when we are separate from each other, we'll end up saying the same thing.
Yeah.
Because we're so used to being in rhythm with each other, and you start to kind of, you feed off each other. You guys have been able to feed off some of the biggest names in the world.
Yeah.
You've shared a stage with Black Coffee, for instance.
Yeah.
How important is it for you guys to see what he's doing and other DJs that are stepping up? The female DJs from South Africa are dominating. How important was that for you in your own career arc to see that, to share a stage with Black Coffee? How important is that for you personally, do you think?
For us, like, for me personally, I've always wanted to share a stage with Black Coffee. So it was one of the biggest highlights of my life. And before even, like, sharing the stage with Black Coffee, seeing Black Coffee playing our music before, us
in New York.
Like, it's like a story. So it's actually a great thing.
Yeah. You got to take on board. There are young kids right now, some pretty tall kids, I would imagine, looking at you going, hang on a minute, I can do this. And their shorter buddies are saying, we can do this together, because you're proving that you can on the biggest stage. But most importantly, they just drop absolute bangers. If you want the weekend to start right now, stick around. It'll start on the other side of a few official duties. I'll get into the sport after Zoe's done the news.
Thank you, Graham. It's 8:02. Let's take a look at those national headlines. The Cape Town Metro says some 16,000 people have been affected by the recent stormy weather in the Western Cape. The spokesperson for disaster management, Charlotte Powell, says more than 7,000 homes have been damaged in informal settlements. Meanwhile, small-scale farmers in Makassar near Somerset West have gratefully welcomed the animal feed delivered by humanitarian group The Gift of the Givers. The farmers say water and grass have been contaminated by a nearby sewage plant, leaving animals with no grazing land. Many have had to be removed to other suitable land. And staying with our local news, Johannesburg has suffered a sharp drop in its reputation as a top financial centre, falling from position 69 to 83 in the Global Financial Centres Index.
Some 121 cities are ranked according to surveys of 147 factors provided by third parties. That includes the World Bank and the United Nations. The factors include the state of the local business environment, human capital, infrastructure, and financial sector development. We now move to news abroad. South Sudan's President Salva Kiir is in Moscow for talks with Russian President Vladimir Putin. The visit comes at a time when Russia and Western powers are trying to woo African support in the wake of the invasion of Ukraine. Kiir arrived in the Russian capital on Wednesday and was received by Deputy Foreign Ministry Andriy Yurovech. Kiir's office said the meeting with the Russian president would be about prospects for the development of bilateral relations in various areas, as well as regional and international issues. Staying with news abroad, Switzerland's glaciers have lost a further 4% of their volume this year, the second biggest loss ever after last year's record melt of 6%. These statistics are in the annual report of the Swiss Glacier Monitoring Network, which has been monitoring 176 of Switzerland's 1,400 glaciers for years. It warns that it may now be too late to save many of the alpine ice fields, even if climate targets are met. In just 2 years, Switzerland's glaciers have lost 10% of their total volume. And a shepherd in Thessaly, Greece, noticed his flock of sheep were acting very weird. In fact, they actually seemed extremely jolly, exhibiting really strange behaviors, such as leaping around even higher than goats and bleating like mad. And then the bamboozled shepherd, Yanis Boronis, spotted the reason why they'd unexpectedly turned bad. They'd accidentally landed in a greenhouse and devoured some 270 kilograms of medical cannabis. However, the farmer has forgiven them as they initially had hastily sought refuge in the aftermath of Major Storm Daniel, which led to extreme flooding in Greece, as well as in Libya, Turkey, and Bulgaria. And naturally, they simply just couldn't withstand the luscious weeds which they had literally stumbled upon. Well, that's where I leave your morning headlines. Let's take a final look at your sport.
I wonder if it affects the flavour. Well, we'll wait and watch that story as it unfolds. But let's start with a brilliant story from yesterday. Laura Volfart, talk about playing a captain's knock yesterday. She led the Proteas women to a 7-wicket victory over New Zealand in, and of course, that victory securing the series 2-0 in favour of the Proteas ladies with one game remaining. So Volfart struck 15 fours on her way to a fourth career century with an unbeaten 124 of 141 deliveries that also etched her name in the history books as the first South African women's player to score more than 3 ODI centuries. And there are a few more, I would imagine, on the way. And South Africa chasing down that 254-run target with ease as former captain Sinead Lewis, who had 53 of 57, carved out her half-century, followed by Marizane Cupp's unbeaten 45 to see us over the line. So that third and final ODI, now with dead rubber, it's underway on Sunday at 9:30 in the morning. Excuse me. Now, we turn to the gents' side, and not the best news as Proteas captain Themba Bavuma has now had to travel back to South Africa from India, citing family reasons for his departure. So consequently, he'll be absent from the Proteas preparation matches for the Cricket World Cup, missing those two warm-ups up against Afghanistan and then New Zealand. In Bavuma's absence, Aidan Markram will take on the role of captain for those friendly games. However, it's anticipated that Bavuma will rejoin the team in time for their World Cup campaign opener up against Sri Lanka, and that's on the 7th of October in Delhi. Now we turn to football, and some stars have been born in a thrilling showdown at the 2023 Varsity Football Final held at UJ Soweto Stadium. Defending champions TUT secured their fourth title by triumphing over UJ in a dramatic penalty shootout. So the match had ended one apiece after regular time, and despite the 2023 Golden Boot winner Ronald Mabaso missing a crucial penalty uncharacteristically, TUT held their nerve in the ensuing penalty shootout to outscore UJ 5-4, thus securing their status as the 2023 Varsity Football Champions for the second consecutive year. Well done. Now let's turn to last night's rugby action ahead of a bumper Rugby World Cup weekend. So Japan made significant progress towards the quarterfinals of the World Cup with a 28-22 victory over Samoa, securing England's spot as Pool D winners now with how the points can play out. So tries from Peter Laboskachny, Michael Leitch and Kazuki Himeno, combined with 13 points from fly half Rekia Matsuda, provided a comfortable lead. And despite a late push from a 14-man Samoa, Japan held on. So Japan is now second place in the pool with 9 points, setting up a crucial clash with Argentina next week. That, of course, if the Pumas can win against Chile, as expected. And, of course, don't forget you can catch all the action live on SABC2 on our radio stations and SABC Plus. No subscription fees apply. And Argentina will clash against Chile at 2:30 in the afternoon tomorrow. And then on Sunday, you can catch the big one. Sia and the boys taking on Tonga live at 8:30 p.m. in the evening. You can watch and show your heels now with freedom. And that's where we leave our sport for this Friday morning. Let's take another look at the roads.
Thank you, Graham. We start off with traffic in Cape Town, Chapman's Peak Drive. It is currently closed until further notice. Please plan your route accordingly. In Johannesburg, Bedford View, there's a stationary vehicle on the N3 northbound at Van Buren. The left lane is closed. Drive carefully. And in East London, in the Eastern Cape, there's protesting on the N6 route at Mpongo. Please use an alternative route this morning and please be safe. That's your traffic. Let's take a final look at your weather. Before we get to your temperatures, a climate expert, Johan Malharba, says the extreme weather patterns in KwaZulu-Natal are the same result, in fact, the result of the same low-pressure system that caused last weekend's flooding in the Western Cape. Malharba says such strong low-pressure systems can develop at any time of the year. However, he says climate change means that more moisture can be expected in the atmosphere, which makes heavy rain possible in shorter periods of time. The Weather Service has, meanwhile, warned that extremely high fire danger conditions are expected over the central and northeastern parts of the Northern Cape, including the west coast of Namakwa, the western part of the Northwest Province, and Mahoeng in the Free State. Well, let's take a look at your temperatures. Those are your temperatures for your Friday. Let's take a final look at your sunrise views. Starting off in Botasig, Dale shared this gorgeous ombre view as the sun rises. Then Dave in Umbilo is up early and shared the red tones in the distance. Louise in Alberton is in her garden sipping on some tea, enjoying the cool breeze. Andy in Switzerland is enjoying a well-deserved holiday and still continue to share a sunrise view with us. Just to go back to another video that Dave shared with us from Umbilo, take a look at the sun rising in the distance. We love seeing those red tones. Well, if you have a good morning video or photo to share with us, you can do so on our WhatsApp line. Our number is 063-408-8863.
So I promised you those Friday feels, Kususa, are here to kickstart the party officially. And we know it's been a long week. We know it's been a tough week. I mean, those shortened weeks often do take it out of us. So we're going to appreciate this weekend even more. Without any further ado, let's get this party started. And to kick off the next stanza of the show, it's Abantu Bako. Ladies and gentlemen, it's Kususa. Take it away, boys.
It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Welcome back. This is your Feel Good Breakfast Show, Espresso on S3. We're in the final hour, and wow, what a busy show it's been.
It's been crazy, and the weekend's only going to get busier because we've got the SAFTAs coming up, and of course, Zozibini Tunzi has been announced as one of the hosts, and she's going to nail it. Let's connect with her and Kutler right now.
Good morning, good morning. Good morning to everyone in studio. Maloney Nanga Mzansi, it's a special Friday because the SAFTAs, 17th annual SAFTAs, are currently underway. I'm with a special guest, Namhlanje. She's no stranger to the Espresso stage, longest reigning Miss Universe. And now she wears the hat of host at the 17th annual SAFTAs tomorrow night, right here at 8 p.m. Give it up for Zozibini Tunzi.
I feel like I see you every month.
I know.
Should we just like set an appointment of like once a month here?
I feel like we need a feature on Espresso, right?
Zozi literally. And
at this come point. On. You are looking sensational.
Thank you. And you, I love the red.
Thank
looking
you.
Stunning.
Thank you. Belated happy birthday.
Thank you so much.
30 is big.
30.
How are you feeling?
I'm feeling great. I mean, I just arrived. There's no... I haven't felt a difference yet, but I'm very excited to see what my 30s look like.
I mean, they're starting off strong because
thank
tomorrow
you.
Night you are hosting the South African Film and Television Awards alongside Lawrence Maleka. Talk mm-hmm. to us about the excitement.
I am so overjoyed. So this is my first time hosting anything live at home.
Yes.
And so there's a lot of excitement that comes with that. And of course, working with Lawrence, who's been doing this for a while, makes it even much better. And I just can't wait. I know there's always people rooting for me.
Yes.
And I know they're going to be so excited to be watching their TVs tomorrow and just, you know, rooting a little bit more.
Absolutely, Zozi. We can't wait to see you in action and for your star to shine brighter. Now, the theme is Our Stories Flow Together. Mm. What's your take on this year's theme?
I think it's a brilliant theme. I mean, if we look at not just South Africa, Africa and Africanism, we're built not on individualism, but a togetherness. Mm-hmm. We have that sense of ubuntu, and in order for us to move forward, it's always nice when we do it together. And maybe being a little bit deep, I feel like the reason why we have so many issues in the world today is because mm-hmm. we've lost, you know, that thing of togetherness. Mm. And through art and film, we're able to tell stories and reinvent ourselves and reintroduce ourselves to the world. And so, you know, that's how I interpret this theme, is we're taking back our power as, you know, per usual, as Africans, and telling our stories, showing our talent. And so I think it's an incredible theme for us.
Mm. Yeah. I mean, what you're saying is so profound. Mm. And what I love about Abantu Balapha eMzansi and just South Africa in general is that we emphasize ubuntu,
absolutely.
Undu, undu, ngabantu, yes. And that translates beautifully in our stories mm-hmm. on television as mm. well. The categories and the talent is intense.
Always insane, right?
It is intense.
It's going to be so difficult, you know, to have a winner and to not have a winner when everyone is just equally brilliant, right?
Exactly. Yeah. But I have to ask, okay, do you perhaps have a favorite category or favorite talent that you would like to see sweep the awards tomorrow?
I mean, category, look, I'm a little bit biased. I'm always for women.
Yes.
So, you know, all the actresses. So I can't wait for that one. It's a big one. There's a lot of incredible actresses in South Africa who are doing it big, and so I think I can't wait to see that big one of who is going to reign supreme.
There are so many big ones, and I think my two favorite ones are the Viewers' Choice Awards, actually.
I agree,
you know,
I agree.
The Best Presenter,
mm-hmm,
the
mm-hmm,
viewers get to vote mm-hmm. for that, and I think the Best Soapy or
best
Telenovela,
soapy. Yes,
right?
Yes, yes, yes.
The viewers have a say in that, and I love how interactive mm-hmm, all mm-hmm. of that is. So we'll see what your fave is, Gomso.
And it matters, right?
It
because
does.
That's they're the ones who are watching and appreciating the talents, and so to see what they like is going to be very fun.
Very interesting.
Yeah, interesting.
Very interesting. So, Gomso, you are hosting with Lawrence Maleka.
Yes.
He is no stranger to the SAFTAs stage.
Yes, yes.
And you did mention you are excited to be working with him. What can we as viewers expect from your partnership tomorrow? Mm. What can we, you know, look forward to?
You know, Lawrence is such a fun guy, but also such a gentleman. And so I think it's going to be interesting to see that mix, you know, between the two of us. And don't want to give away too much, but we're going to be having so much fun. And I hope that you guys are going to be having that fun with us. And I can't wait for you guys to see all of it.
And you mentioned something so interesting earlier, Ngubana. This will be the first time on this big stage in South Africa.
In South Africa, yes.
Live. You've taken over the Miss Universe stage, Zozi. And you are the longest reigning Miss Universe. And you did that other award show in Nigeria.
That one.
Wink, wink. But this one is the first time. Do you get nervous at all?
I do get nervous like 5 seconds before stepping onto stage, but a day before and 3 days before, I'm just really relaxed about it. Mm-hmm. But we all get nerves. Yeah. I'm sure you do too. Yes. And I'm so excited for you tonight. Please, come on. You are going to be so incredible, and I just can't wait to see you shine on that stage as well.
You know, for some reason, I consider Uzozi as my good luck charm. I think day one of rehearsals, I heard Uzozi... Girl, I heard Uzozi is in studio, mm-hmm. Or at the center, and I was like, I have to see this girl. Where is she? Where is she? That was day one, and I was full of nerves. But you looked so calm. You were like, oh, girl, hi.
You got it. You got it. I'll give you some of that calm again. You'll be fantastic.
Please. We'll be great.
We'll be great.
Yes.
Watch us
tonight. The 29th of September on the SAFTA's YouTube page, we are going to be live with Carl Wasty at the Craft Awards. It's going to be absolutely fantastic. Ngomso. Mm-hmm. Zozi Bini Tunzi alongside Lawrence Waleka will be holding it down on the main show, the main stage, live at 8 p.m., right?
Yeah.
At 8 p.m. Mm-hmm. on S3. And there's a different channel as well that's going it's going to be airing on. You do not want to miss out. Do you actually want to punt it yourself, Zozi?
Do I want to?
To punt the show yourself and be like, better make sure to tune in tomorrow.
Okay, let me look at the more than intimidating look.
Yes.
You better watch me tomorrow. Remember, I used to own the keys to the universe. I will lock you up. I still have. They never took the key away. So please. Catch us tomorrow on S3.
Catch her tomorrow on S3. And if you want to talk about part of the universe, get it right. And this is exactly how we start the day here live in Johannesburg with Zozi Bini Tunzi. It has been absolutely fantastic. See you tonight on the SAFTA's YouTube page. And of course, tomorrow night on S3 with the beautiful Zozi Bini Tunzi.
Bye.
Back to you guys in studio.
Two unbelievably talented young ladies about to dominate and own that stage. The keys to the universe, she's still got them, and she can unlock more for our local stars. Why? Because the SAFTAs are big.
Oh.
They are massive.
And we are looking forward to it. Now, the SAFTAs, which is the South African Film and Television Awards, it is this weekend, and we asked you this morning, we're going to be celebrating the best in film and TV. So who do you think will walk away with the coveted golden horn? Send us your voice notes, let us know on Facebook, so let's take a look at what you had to say.
And it's always tough. There are so many great nominees, but this year I think this man's going to get his due. Katlego, my boy, you got this one, brother, all the way. Norma Kosozana sending that one in. I love it. Thank you so much. We are behind you 100%.
Teresa says, good morning, my favorite Beautiful Espresso family, our very own Kat. Wishing him all the best. He definitely deserves it.
Oh, yes, he does. Absolutely love it. Please send those messages of love to whoever you are supporting this edition of the SAFTAs. It matters so much to them, so please do it. And then, of course, we've got the small matter of a little break, and then afterwards we get moving. It's time for the Friday dance.
Now we need to still go head to head on a bit of a lyric match, but we're super excited for that Friday dance that's coming your way, so stay tuned.
Let me tell you.
It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Welcome back, your beauties. It's time to turn up the volume for another game of Lyric Match. And this will strike fear into both mine and Zoe's hearts because we are the least musical people on this set, but we need to learn. So this is how the game works. We're going to see a couple of lyrics, a line or two from a song. We've got to guess the artist who sang it. It's as easy as that, Zoe. It sounds so simple, doesn't it?
It sounds simple, but the problem is when you make up your own lyrics, you don't really know the real lyrics of a song, so this is going to be challenging.
Or this is going to be an educational process, so please play along with us at home. We don't know the answers, so we are going head-to-head with one another. I think we drew the price game. Let's give this one a go.
Okay.
Right, our first lyric. I've been on my own for long enough. Maybe you can show me how to love.
Oh, I'm going to go with B, The Weeknd.
I feel it's The Weeknd. They've given us A or B options here, which helps me a lot. I'm going to agree with you there. I'm going to agree with you. Is it
The
Weeknd?
Is that the answer?
Yay! I love The Weeknd so much. I love Adele, but I love The Weeknd. Oh, actually, I love this. Oh.
You know this?
How do I not know the words for this? How do I not know that that's that song? Oh. I love it. We're off to an absolute banger here. Well done, Zoe. Okay, we got to make a decision. Leave tonight or live and die this way. I'm going to go with A.
Ooh, I don't know.
I think it's Fast Car, I'm sure, I hope. I'm going to say Tracy Chapman A.
I feel like you convinced me now to choose A, but just because of, I'm unsure, I'm going to go with B.
It's honestly one of the greatest songs that's ever been written or made, so I should have known that, but I am quite a bit older than you. So, I was around when this actually came out. Oh, it's stunning, man. Don't laugh, Lucian. Absolutely beautiful. Okay,
Let's look at the next one.
Oh, this one is nice. Some people want diamond rings. Some just want everything.
That is A, Alicia Keys.
Oh, you see, we're better than we think. That's definitely Alicia Keys. What a song. Oh. Whoever curated this playlist. Oh, absolutely beautiful. I love it. Okay, we are rocking it. We're doing
time
okay.
For one more?
Oh, we're going to squeeze in a few more if we can, man. These songs are so good. I know that you're going to have it your way or nothing at all, but I think you're moving too fast.
Ooh.
TLC, 100%.
I feel like that's TLC. I also went for TLC. I'm going to go for
Waterfalls,
option B.
Baby. It's been a while since the Stank Face has come out. But for TLC, you'll do it.
I'm just surprised the Meerkat didn't come out.
Oh, where the Friday dance is still coming, eh? It's still coming. Sure, some absolute bangers this morning. I love it. Okay, let's squeeze in one more. If I could find a way, I'd take back those words that have hurt you.
Ooh, that sounds like a Cher song.
It does, hey.
Cher.
I want to sing it in the funny accent. Yeah, I don't know. I can't associate Selena Gomez, so I'm going to go Cher as well. Okay. It's the one of those that if I did know it, I wasn't going to admit that I did know it, okay? Nice. Okay, we've had a nice eclectic mix of songs this morning. Let's see where our journey is going to take us now.
Oh,
here
cool.
We come. Here we go. We got to rock. Easy come, easy go. Now we're on top. Come on.
Oh, that's the Black Eyed Peas.
It's got to be. I saw them live at Sun City, and they were amazing. Now it's feeling like The Weeknd. When are we going to have them on this show? I love it. Okay, I'm actually enjoying this so much more than I thought we would. Let's squeeze in one more. Where do you leave?
They keep squeezing more.
I'm begging you not to go. I'm just until we get one wrong, man. Call your name 2-3 times in a row.
Ooh, I think that's B, Drake.
Drake. Okay, go for it. I'll go with B, with Drake as well.
It's supposed to be a competition.
Let's see. Beyonce. Oh, you see, now they're going to come for us. Oh, yeah. Oh, well, we should have known this. It's like one of her best as well. But look, I'm not part of Beehive, not because I dislike her, okay? It's just not what I prefer.
Difficult to see lyrics.
I know.
And you just don't hear them. It's different.
Oh, can we get a round of applause for the song choice this morning? Zozo, we are not as bad as we think we are. I love it. That's how much music can enhance your life. Music makes all the difference. So when you want to enhance yours, look no further than Vodacom. You can now access the latest smart tech like buds, like headphones, like speakers to your existing plan, and even get 3 months Apple Music for free when you add that service to your bill.
That is the Vodacom Enhance, and all the super easy and super customizable. And to view all of these epic deals and devices on offer, you can visit Vodacom Enhance on the website vodacom.co.za.
And what I like about this is you can enhance your existing contract so you know what works. But I think everyone's got a contract where you've taken like a compromise. The best deals based sort of on what you want. Now you can tailor it exactly how you want it, which I absolutely love as well. We do love a little bit of dancing, so maybe it's time to start warming up.
Mzansi, enhance what you love. Add more of what you need to your contract. Choose from a range of enhanced options in-store or online. Further together, Vodacom.
Well, listen, we promised you Friday Dance and Dance Sport Club League DSCL. It is a high-performance dance competition between clubs and studios. And DSCL runs a similar structure to other major sporting codes like society, in fact, like netball, soccer, rugby, just to name a few, where clubs compete in weekly fixtures to ultimately find out who is the best in the province.
I absolutely love it. Now, the top athletes slash dancers will then advance further to represent their provinces in the interprovincial tournaments and then ultimately represent their country internationally. And here to showcase their incredible talents are Dance Sports Club League of the Western Cape for officially, baby, the Espresso Friday Dance. Take it away! Come on!
Let me tell you. You my little poop thing, so I'll give a hoot what you do. Say, girl, I know you a little too tame. I'll be shooting that shot like 2K, girl, I know. Tell him I'm next. Tell him you find a little something too fresh, I know. Tell him I'm next. Tell him you find a little something too fresh, I know.
I'm going to hop along this way so everyone can see me. We are, that was amazing. Give yourself a round of applause. Aww. It's literally like having a live studio audience. It's amazing. We are taking the quickest of breaks. The Friday dance is not going anywhere. And then it's all about the braai for the boys. So stay tuned to your Feel Good Breakfast Show.
it's my Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Welcome back. It is your Feel Good Breakfast Show. It's been a busy Friday, but we are going to continue with all the fun. Now, when it comes to Brian, the boys love to do all of the hard work, and we want to make sure it's made easy with Woolworths. So let's connect with the gents as they enjoy another braai for your Friday.
Thank you, Yanka.
I love it. This kind of activity means you've got three braai masters trying to decide who's actually going to do the braaiing. So we're going to have to, let Chef Clem do it. Andit Lepo is here. He's the mad scientist behind that meat. So we thought we'd connect you with our mad scientist who comes up with recipes in his dreams.
In the dreams.
Amazing things. I know we love you, guy, because you're behind this incredible selection of meat at Woolies. Yes. We are so spoiled when it comes to a braai weekend, to a big bok weekend. There are so many cuts of meat that you guys hero, and each one is a hero. So walk us through the meat that has got you most excited.
Yeah, so look, I mean, let me talk about, I'll talk about our difference today when it comes to our steaks. So the biggest difference, I'll talk about our free range, which we've got here in front of us today. The biggest difference with us is that our steaks are matured for the minimum of 35 days. That minimum of 35 days ensures that the product is going to be succulent, the flavor is going to be there, and it's just going to eat like a million bucks.
And it matters, and it really
absolutely
does.
You can matter. See, you can see that we also guarantee the product to be tender and succulent. So I mean, it's just that process that we take the product through from a maturation point of view. So
when you go to a person's house and taste their steak, if they complain that it's just not soft enough,
I can tell them that it's not from Woolies.
I love it. So we've got the heroes there. We've got a rump steak. We've got our ribeye. Talk us through the kind of seasoned steaks. Yeah. I love that.
Yeah, so as you chatted, so we've got the primal ones, which I referred to, which are the ones which aren't seasoned, which are the plain ones. The ones that are seasoned, then we've got a barbecue one, which we've got in sirloin, and then we've got a ribeye one. Sorry, we don't have the ribeye one here, but we've got a rump one here as well. So we've got all three cuts. We've got your ribeye, your rump, and your sirloin, also marinated and also just in plain primal.
I love that because people kind of tend towards their steak.
Yeah.
They like a steak. I'm a ribeye kind of guy. Okay. I find it's the best on balance. Some people must have a rump steak on the braai.
Mm-hmm.
Other people like Chef Clem must have every steak on
the braai. Whole cow. The whole cow. And you know, the thing is, as a chef, I'm very excited and always inspired by South African food. And it's because of people like Anda. I mean, every year I get so excited to find out what new delicious goodness is Anda going to be bringing out. And this year has not disappointed
Thank
by
you.
Any means. The cuts are amazing. The marinades are sensational. What I also love is Woolies knows it's not just about the place. You got to have the sides.
It's almost as important to hero the meat. You've got to have a side that lets it sing.
Exactly. Absolutely.
Okay, so what are the sides that we're playing with today?
We've got the iconic potato salad.
Thank you.
You can't go wrong with the potato salad. We've got salads when it comes to Woolies. I love the fact that you can kind of pick salads according to your palate. Okay. There's a beautiful selection of what you can get when it comes to salads. And then the newest addition are these amazing pumpkin delicious. Rings. Oh. And these are delicious. I love reheating these on the braai to get a little bit of that smoke.
Oh, yes.
It's delicious.
Completely.
It's delicious. And you got to have a garlic bread. Let me tell you what else we've done.
Okay, please.
So we've got some garlic mushrooms on the braai. Once it gets like a nice bit of color on it, you're going to use the Woolies roast garlic sauce.
Ooh.
And who made this? Because this stuff is so good.
It's delicious.
It's delicious. So it's a bit of a hack. We don't want you to spend all the time busy cooking. Saving your time.
It's nice roasting your own garlic because that was a
convenience
big hack for me. Mm. Yeah, use the air fryer, roast some garlic, roast your tomatoes, do those things. But when you've got the mad scientists at Woolies, just thinking of the most delicious ways of making life easier for you.
This is how you do it.
This is it. Because roast garlic lands different. It's a different flavor, man.
For sure. Mm. And I mean, you can already imagine these beautiful steak that Anda's worked so hard on to get them perfect. Served with this roasted garlic mushroom sauce. You definitely are going to want to add a lot of pepper to this one.
Yes.
It can only be delicious.
And there must be such debate when you guys are thinking about the cuts to go with, the kinds of meats. Because, yes, you want to be trend-driven, but you also need to deliver on what you've been doing in the past.
Absolutely.
So you guys kind of set the trends.
Yes, yeah, no, you know, we set the trends, I say. I mean, look, we look at various trends locally and also, more importantly, internationally. We travel a lot. We eat out at places. You know, you've got to know what's happening out there. Also, just to jump as well, you know, as I said, we do have these steaks here. But if you do go to our Woolies butcher counters, which we've also got nationwide, you're guaranteed to find Wagyu steaks there, which are outstanding.
Mm.
We don't have them at the retail side, but we've got them in our butcher counters. We've got 12 in Western Cape and 28 up in Gauteng.
And it's worth it. If you want to invest in a beautiful piece of meat,
treat yourself.
Wagyu. Or if you want to buy someone special in your life, something like that,
It really is worth it.
Yes. It is.
Oh, look
at that bubbling sauce. I mean, and we made this almost real time. Those mushrooms took a minute to brown off. That. What I do is I like serve it just like this on the table. You want that bubblage, served with these beautiful steaks on the side. I mean, you have to let these steaks rest
the
as well.
The steaks do need to rest, so you've got to have a couple of things, you know, to kind of let people ease that transition between. But I would recommend with a braai like this, keep it simple. Mm, if you're going to have steak, don't have too much other protein.
Absolutely.
Hero the steak, because it really is worth it. On the braai.
Talk to me.
What is the best way? How do you cook your steak on the braai?
I do like when the cuts aren't too thick to go really hard and fast. Yeah, exactly. Get it. But like, you know what? People turn their steaks too quickly. They're scared of a bit of char.
Yeah.
Get a crust on it. Get some flavor. Because once you slice that, you're going to have minimal amount of char versus meat. Nice and crusty. Big steak, go hard and fast. When you got a thicker cut, that's when I turn a little more often than with the thinner ones. Take your time. You're allowed to turn your steak more than once.
Absolutely.
Yeah, for sure.
Turn your steak as much as you need to. Do that.
Listen, if you've been braaiing for the last few years, you are your own braai master.
Absolutely.
You know how you like it. No one comes and tells you how to do anything unless they're an older generation, then you've just got
to
forgive
them. And you must listen to the worms, eh? Take the advice from the worms. They also know what they're doing. But Woolies, when it comes to people who know what they're doing, it's guys like Anda and Woolies that just keep on delivering. I've never been so stoked for braai season before. I will officially try everything that Anda has made.
I'm going to this make my wish, but now the family's away, so I'm cooking for one every night.
Hey, that's fine.
One steak a night is just perfect. I'm going to ask you, Anda, seeing as you're the guy.
Yes.
Okay, and I know this is very much subjective. Yes. What's your best steak for the braai?
My best steak for the braai? That's a tough one, it's a tough one. Very contentious. But I think if it's not a rump, we do have what is called a picanha. Picanha is basically, it's the top cap of the rump here. It's where the fat sits.
That's the
I think one of the best cuts that you could do on the braai. Very underrated, but once you put it on the braai, hot flames, I think the flavour that comes out of there. Strong beefy notes. And
guests are always surprised when they see it on the braai, they go, what's that?
It is so
special. I mean, it's size and that shape.
Yeah.
And I always talk about the fact picanha is a great steak when you're serving a lot of people.
Yes.
Because if you have people that like their steaks a little more rare, and you've got a group of people that like their steaks a little more cooked,
you can give them the tail end.
It's the steak that feeds everyone. And you know they say you can't please everyone all the time. With picanha, you can.
Absolutely.
You can.
I love that, man. I love the fact that you've got a choice for everybody here. I'm thinking my braai day, next braai day, is going to have no other meats. I'm just going to try a selection of five or six different kinds of steaks. I know it hasn't rested for long enough, but would you like a little taste?
Absolutely. Under, will you do the honor?
Which one should I go for? The ribeye hasn't rested enough. I think maybe let's start with this one here.
With the humble sirloin, and I love sirloins because they're perfect. They're great value for money. You get the fatty flavor.
Mm.
They've got some nice marbling. They're a perfect little well-balanced steak. I got to say, I like, because of the fat strip, I do love a rump on the... Oh, look at that.
Look at that. Job. Whoa.
So, as I said, this one hasn't rested enough, but I'm going to take the chance. You've got to rest your steak for at least half the time that you've cooked it for, I think. And don't be shy about resting it, so...
Yeah, and I found with a steak, a little gentle reheat won't destroy it if you've let it rest for too long. But if you don't rest it for long enough, your steak is done.
That's called a... Mistake.
See, I've been in the steak game long enough.
I love it.
Oh, buddy, on behalf of everyone who braaies, thank you, bro.
Thank you.
thank you.
Your team have outdone it. You've also made these really premium cuts accessible through the pricing as well. So thank you so much. I would, though, really suggest go and chat to your Woolies butcher if you can. Get yourself a bit of Wagyu. We love you guys. This is the boys, braai. Yo. Oh, this looks good.
Oh, gents, thank you so much. Getting us so excited for this weekend to really get the braais going. Well, we're about to finish off your Feel Good Breakfast show, and we can't do that without one more Friday dance. So stay tuned to your Feel Good Breakfast show.
Crouch, touch, but don't you dare pause. Because when you buy any of our favorite Clover products, keep the till slip handy and catch the Espresso Breakfast show every weekday morning for more details on how to enter. While the Bucks are battling for rugby's greatest prize, you can win your share of 80,000 rands worth of Weber Braais. So engage and win with rugby's greatest moments, brought to you with love by Clover.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
Welcome back. We promised you a Friday dance and we are ready to deliver. Now, the Dance Sports Club League, it brings talented dancers together from various clubs and schools and crews. And they form one big representation, that of the Western Cape. And today we've been spoiled with two incredible performances. And this is the Dance Sports Club League dancers of the Western Cape for the Espresso Friday dance. And if we have time, we're also going to squeeze in another bit of a performance from that dynamic duo Kasusa. So stay tuned, because all is happening right now.
Drink from forbidden, that's forbidden, that's forbidden. Drink from the forest.
incredible representation we have that the Western Cape has to offer. You are all so talented. Give yourself another round of applause. Now, today, we have been blessed with this dynamic duo named Kasusa, and we're going to ask them to play, and you guys have the floor to do a bit of a freestyle. How does that sound? Should we do that? Please. Kasusa, take it away.
Thank you.
way to end the week to these unbelievably talented young dancers, bearing in mind they're all competitors against one another, but dancing for one vision today. Thank you for being part of such an amazing movement. Thank you for being so unbelievably good at what you do. Now go out there and represent. Represent your province, represent your hood, represent your country, because this is how you do it. Well done. Thank you so much to the gents who've given us the beats. Thank you for the boys around the braai. Absolutely amazing way to round off the week. And of course, it is going to be the biggest weekend in our industry, the SAFTAs, the Craft Awards tonight, where our very own Kutle and Carl will be hosting. So proud of both of them. Then the big one tomorrow night, where we award all of your fan favorites, the guys that you love, the girls that inspire you. It's your opportunity to show them some love. So if you've got those stars nominated, go and support them. If your vote matters, like it does when it comes to favorite TV presenter of the year, I'm just saying Kat is waiting. Okay, go and vote, go and show some love, and most importantly, show some love to them.
Another feel-good production.
We are back with the gents from Kusasa. Kususa. Someone from Kosasa is going to come after me and ask you guys to be like the shop stewards or something for the next year. Guys, thank you so much for playing along. You are really good at what you do.
Thank you.
Which takes a lot to find yourself, to carve your path up to the pinnacle of your job. And I know you aren't there yet, but it takes a huge amount. You need the fans to come and see you to experience this properly. It's one thing seeing it on TV. It's another thing when you feel the vibes. When are you guys gigging? How can we stay connected to where you're going to be playing?
So tonight, we're playing here in...
People want you to start right now. They're like, start the weekend. I love that.
Tonight, we're playing here in Cape Town in Modular and Drama.
Okay.
And we have like a few shows until Sunday in Cape Town. But like, if you want to reach out to us or DM, whatever, it's at Kususa Official One word, K-U-S-U-S-A.
It's not as easy as it sounds, eh?
Official, one word throughout social media. So Instagram, YouTube, Facebook, yeah.
Absolutely cool. And I would imagine you're open to collabs. You're open of to course, people sending you samples. Yeah, so if you think you are the voice, if you are the voice to guide us into a new era of music, send them a sample, man. No, guys, thank you so much for helping us officially kickstart the weekend. What are you, what song are you going to use to do that?
When I play our remix, Kususa, Ipat.
Party. Okay, yeah. Gents, we are here for anything that you do. We are here for this. And we are here to see the next big stage of your career, because I think you guys are knocking on that door. So thank you so thank much you. For making us a part of your journey. Ladies and gentlemen, one last time. Kususa. Let's rock. You know what I love? That was so nice. I think someone's party that they had like in 2001 just kicked back in. Really. Like, oh, yeah, it's my jam. Boys, thank you so much for bringing all of this down to Cape Town. The mother city needs jams like this. It's been a tough year, man. I don't think you guys appreciate just how much you help us process and just let go and do our thing. There's a reason why DJs are the rock stars of this era. I think you guys capture that. So thank you so much. Head over to their socials, follow them, like them, download, do whatever you can to support outfits like this. And most importantly, check them out on the socials to find out where they're gigging so you can experience this firsthand. But from our family to your family, and you're now part of our family, thank you so much. We love you, brothers. You guys go out and have the most amazing weekend. Just be super, super safe out there. You have a feeling it's going to be a big party weekend, so just look after yourselves and, of course, enjoy the rugby. The Springboks taking on Tonga at 8:30. The coverage starts on SABC2. You can watch it live and all of the SABC platforms, radio and plus, without subscriptions. Free to air, baby. We're here for that. We're here for these guys. We are here for you on Monday morning. We'll see you then. Mwah. Adios, muchachos.
Thank you.
Oh, well done, boys.